this season. The Tigers, again, have lost three straight coming in. Of course, we had a chance to visit with Coach Ryan Bowen last night at the 818 Diner for our coaches show. Rangers, again, this week had their annual hot dogs and apple pie game. Obviously, wasn't the outcome they were kind of looking for. Coach Bowen kind of discussed that with us and kind of what happened. It really just got away from them. And you never know with a game like that. It didn't count towards anything with the conference. It's still a game that you obviously wanted to go out and win. But there may have been a little bit of looking ahead to this weekend series.
Yeah, and I don't know if it has a regional impact also. It may not be conference, but every game kind of gets looked at regionally. You know, and I wasn't able to attend, but I did catch some of the game. When I had bad performances, not so much as a player but as a coach, we'd have a group spit afterwards just to get that out of our mouth. And so maybe, you know, see if they turn that into a positive. You know, I'm sure they weren't proud of the effort and the way things went the other night.
Now, again, Rangers fell 12-2 to Southern Nazarene on Tuesday night in Enid. Again, we're about 10 minutes from the opening pitch. Let's go through your starting lineups brought to you by the Alva Moose Lodge for the visiting Weevils of Arkansas Monticello. Leading off and playing center will be number one, Rock Hawthorne. The batting second will be the right fielder, number five, Camden Tanner. Batting third, the first baseman, number 18, Cade Cancia. Batting cleanup will be the catcher, number two, Chaz Poppy. And Poppy, a tremendous catcher and a good hitter. He was the second-team All-Great American Conference performer a year ago back this year with the Weevils. Batting fifth will be the second baseman, number nine, Chase Cripps. He actually was a Great American Conference honorable mention, led the team in hitting a year ago, hitting .344. Batting sixth will be the left fielder, number 19, Kirk Wolf. Batting seventh, the shortstop, number 14, Aiden Garrett. Batting eighth will be the third baseman, number 23, Braden Romero. And batting ninth, the DH, number 12, Logan Jones. Getting the start for the Weevils this afternoon will be number 20, Connor Irvin. Irvin, a 6-foot, 200-pound junior out of Lassen Community College out of Victoria, B.C. And Connor Irvin has, you know, the interesting matchup of these two pitchers is, you know, the Rangers are going to go with Garrett DeHaas today. Both of them are probably two of the most improved pitchers from a year ago. Irvin a year ago was 7-5, had a 4.55 earned run average. This season, his earned run average has dropped considerably. It's down to 3.47, and DeHaas's is down as well. So we've got a tremendous pitching matchup for game one.
Yeah, and maybe it's also learning that you've got players behind you and just challenge the hitters.
And that was one of the points that Coach Bowen made last night, just how good the Rangers are defensively. They're 15th in Division II in fielding percentage. And I know they had two errors the other night, but before that, Rangers have been really, really clean most of the year.
Oh, yeah. The glove work out there is fun to watch.
Starting lineup for the Rangers looked like this. Leading off and playing first, number 7, Dylan Bradford. Batting second, the left fielder, number 31, Carson Wright. Batting third, the right fielder, number 6, Paul Sache, and the DH, Chad Green, will bat fourth. Batting fifth, back into the lineup. We'll see how it goes today. The second baseman, number 10, Hagen Barcelo. Good to have him back. Batting sixth will be the center fielder, number 27, Trevor Sayre. Batting seventh, the third baseman, Colby Grace. Batting eighth, the catcher, number 20, Trevor Stiles. And batting ninth, the shortstop, number 9, Jacob Wiltshire. Had a chance to talk to Dylan Bradford's dad right before we went on the air, and he was telling me about him and Jacob Wiltshire, about how they've played together since they were really, really young kids, both at Cochise and, again, junior community college. So that's really cool that they've been teammates for that long.
Yeah, two really good players, and the fact that they both landed here is a testament to our recruiting efforts and our desire to get good ball players here.
We talked about just how good the Rangers are defensively with Bowen last night, and I mentioned it about Wiltshire and Sayre and a lot of these guys too, but those two guys really just stand out defensively, just how good Jacob Wiltshire is at shortstop.
Yeah, really smooth, and I've commented, you know, there may be a better shortstop in the conference, but I've not seen him yet.
Few losses that Arkansas Monticello had from a year ago. They did have the GAC, Great American Conference Pitcher of the Year, first team All-GAC, Mason Philly is gone. The guy who led the team in saves, River Hunt, who was a second team All-GAC performer, he is gone. And then first team, Kate Thompson. So they did lose a few, but UAM did a good job of plugging those holes. And that's why, again, they come in with a very good record in conference play. They struggled out of conference. When you look at it, again, they're 20-17, 16-8, so they went just 4-9 against non-conference opponents. But hey, that's what you do when you get in conference play. You turn it around, and they certainly have.
Well, and I don't know who they played, but you do want to challenge yourself against good teams. I mean, you don't want gimme games. They're not really going to help you much. So maybe that's what they did. And again, with each team as the season goes, you figure things out. And sometimes you get stronger, and other times, you know, you're battling injuries, and you're still trying to figure out a rotation, positions for players. But we'll see what happens here.
Let's take a 30-second break as we'll come back. We're moments away from the national anthem. That's coming up right after this. This is Northwestern Baseball, brought to you by Holder Drug on the Ranger Sports Network.
Holder Drug has been serving the community of Alva since 1952. When you are in need of medication, healthcare items, and more, look to none other than Holder Drug, Alva's local pharmacy. Holder Drug is locally and family-owned and is always ready to serve you. They offer convenient drive-through pickup as well as free delivery with your medication. They also offer a number of gift ideas for those special holidays. For more information, visit their website, www.holderdrug.com, or stop by 513 Barnes Avenue in downtown Alva.
Community Bank has been serving Alva, Oklahoma, and the surrounding area since 1984. Community Bank was founded by local community members who wanted to ensure the banking needs of the community were being met. It has been our goal since inception to provide customer-focused services and community development. Our customers are friends, neighbors, and never just a number. We believe in investing in our community, and we pride ourselves in being your hometown bank. Community Bank, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
Notes of the Star Spangled Banner. We get close to opening pitch here between Northwestern and Arkansas Monticello. Let's take a 30-second break. We'll come back and open it up after this. This is Northwestern Baseball, brought to you by Holder Drug on the Ranger Sports Network 105.7.
Do you need assistance taking care of yourself or a loved one? Beatles Nursing Home in Alva is here for you. We offer safe, high-quality, affordable nursing care while meeting all care guidelines for living. Call us at 580-327-1274 to learn more about our admissions process to place your loved one in our care. When it's time to choose a nursing home facility, we'll hope you'll consider Beatles Nursing Home, located at 916 Noble Street in Alva.
Welcome back here to Glass Family Field at Meyer Stadium as we're about ready to go with the opening pitch between Northwestern and Arkansas Monticello. Again, let's go through the series history real quick. Arkansas Monticello does lead at 20-13. In fact, they've won three straight against the Rangers. All those games were in Monticello a year ago. But when you look at the last 10 between these two teams, they've actually split. It's been 5-5 over the last 10. And so, again, it's definitely been a good matchup here, really, between these two schools since both teams have entered Great American Conference play. And originally scheduled to start at 3 o'clock. It's going to be probably right at about 3 or maybe just a moment before. Of course, we're going to have hot dogs, brats. That's going to be later on tonight, courtesy of the Bull Smokehouse and Saloon, Northwestern Student Government Association. Is there anything Olivia Yandell doesn't do? That SGA group will have free snow cones out here.
Well, I think Widdits is a part of this also.
You're right, you're
and,
right.
Now Olivia's everywhere. I saw legend Mike Perkins somewhere out there in the stands earlier, and I saw that he was in Enid Tuesday night. So he and his wife are probably making the circuit, and I think he's going to follow him to Tahlequah before they go back to Georgia. Happy birthday to Rick Brown today. Who's he's here. I saw him pull in.
Barrett ready to go with the opening pitch as Rock Hawthorne, the center fielder, steps in, and it's in there from DeHaas for a called strike. Count is 0-1, and we are underway. That opening pitch brought to you by Ridgeview Vet Hospital. Hawthorne this season, 349 hitter, 24 start, as there's a high bouncer to second, fielded by Barcelo, throws to first in time, and a good start on the ground ball. It's a 4-3 putout, and there's one down. Of course, DeHaas getting the start today, 3.15 earned run average. He's 3-1. He's been brilliant his last four starts. This is his 11th start of the season, 54 1/3, 50 hits, 23 runs, 19 of those earned, 26 walks to 45 strikeouts. Teams are hitting just 244 or 242 against DeHaas this season as Camden Tanner, the right fielder, steps into the batter's box and takes it low for ball one.
First two hitters are left-handed.
Here's the 1-0. That's in there for a called strike. Count evens up 1-1. Again, this is game one of a doubleheader. Game two scheduled to start at 6 p.m. later on this evening as DeHaas just missed outside there as the count moves to 2-1. The Rangers again, 26-13, 16-8 in conference. They've just been terrific here at home, 19-4. As that pitch is fouled off to the left as it gets out of play. And something I was talking about with Coach Bowen, and I've been here since 2008. Coach, you may know this. That may be one of the better home records we've seen from a Ranger baseball team in a long, long time.
Yeah, off the cuff, I don't know. But, it's kind of dominating here, and that's what you want.
2-2 pitch is ball three. Count goes full 3-2 to Camden Tanner.
It's a lot like basketball, soccer, softball. I mean, you want to win your games at home.
3-2 pitch to the 400 hitter is outside for ball four, and it's a one-out walk drawn by Camden Tanner. That's his 12th walk of the season. He's got an on-base percentage of nearly 500.
Yeah, boy, that's what you want, first or second hole.
Now stepping in will be the first baseman, number 18, Cade Kinsella. Kinsella again, 6'3 junior out of Three Rivers Community College, Paragould, Arkansas. And see a second on the team hitting 331 this season as he'll look at a called strike. Count is 0-1.
I was talking with Coach Pickford a few days ago and asked him if DeHaas was throwing a cutter, and he said, no, it's a slider. And so that's a dropping.
That's what that was right there.
Yeah.
The 0-1 pitch, and oh, that was up and in. And see, actually went around kind of half swing that time and fouled it off to the right.
Pretty much defended himself because it was breaking up and in on him.
No balls, two strikes. Kinsella, again, 331 hitter, 36 starts, 42 hits, and 127 at-bats this season. He's also scored 15 runs. Throwing back over, getting back safely as Tanner. Kinsella, of those 42 hits, he does have 9 doubles, which is second on the team. 1 triple, one of the 3 triples hit this year. 4 home runs to 32 RBIs, which is second on the team as well. DeHaas delivers the 0-2. That one's popped up into foul territory down the right field line, and Bradford shading the sun will make the grab for out number 2.
Textbook technique there. Saw go up, put his glove up in front of the sun, and track the ball right into his glove. Textbook.
2 down here in the top of the first. Again, no score. As the catcher, number 2, Chaz Poppy, will step in. A 301 hitter. 36 start for Poppy. 43 hits and 143 at-bats. 29 runs, 6 doubles. Second on the team at home runs with 6. There's the delivery upstairs to Poppy. Misses for ball one. Every time I hear Poppy, I think of Seinfeld, the episode with Poppy's restaurant.
Oh. I think of Poppy Fields. That's, way that's not good first. Word association.
Yeah. Here's the 1-0. That one into the turf. Nice stop from Stiles, and we'll hold the runner at first. Count will move to 2-0 now.
Well, I doubt the coach will send him on this 2-0 count. See if he can throw a strike here.
Tanner does have 4 stolen bases and 6 attempts this season for the Weevils. Throw back over. Camden Tanner gets back safely. The And two balls, no strikes to the hitter, Chaz Poppy. Throw back over again. Tanner gets back safely once more. There's the 2-0 from DeHaas. That's across the plate for a called strike. Count evens up 2-1.
That was a good take by the hitter. That was a little bit up and on the outside, and not what he was looking for.
DeHaas with the 2-1. That's a fly ball hit high and hard into left, going back, and that one sails over the wall for a two-run home run off the bat of Chaz Poppy. Give him 7 home runs and 33 RBIs, and it's 2-0 Arkansas Monticello.
Yeah, I think that a lot of runs to be had today, especially with this wind and two really good clubs, but that ball saw too much at the plate. Batter turned on it. It looked like it was a slider.
So Poppy delivers here in the top of the first. Weevil's leading it now 2-0 on the Community Bank scoreboard as Chase Cripps, the second baseman, will step into the batter's box. A 258 hitter as the count moves to 1-0. Cripps with 24 hits, 93 at-bats, his 30th start of the year. He's also scored 12 runs as he looks at a called strike. Count evens up 1-1 to Chase Cripps. 7 doubles, no triples, 2 home runs to go along with 19 RBIs. Well, it was a good pitch from DeHaas. Did get the call, though, as the count moves to 2-1.
Yeah, that was a good pitch.
Here's the 2-1 delivery. That's a towering fly ball foul to the left as it gets out of play. It'll get into the parking lot. Count will even up 2-2 now.
Have you ever heard a ball hit a car and the alarm go off? Here?
If I have, it's been a while. Not recent years, anyway. 2-2 from DeHaas. That misses high for ball three. Count goes to 3-2 now. Three-two pitch, and it's ball four. Second walk issued by DeHaas here in the first. And the Weevils have a base runner with two down as Chase Cripps walks for the 17th time this season.
Now batting left fielder, Kirk Wolf.
As the left fielder, number 19, Kirk Wolf steps in, a 275 hitter, 32nd start, 30 hits and 109 at-bats. He also scored 27 runs this season. First pitch, Wolf looks at a called strike, count is 0-1.
Dr. Dina Walker is back to feeling a little better. She's out here. I saw her in the bleachers.
The 0-1 pitch, just a bit high, apparently. Count evens up 1-1. That's a pitch you're going to want today, too, if you're DeHaas or you're hoping to get.
I mean, that guy's not my size in the box. That was a strike.
1-1. Grounder hit foul to the left side. Count will move to 1-2 now. The numbers on Kirk Wolf this season. Again, 32nd start. 30 hits, 109 at-bats, 27 runs. Does have 8 doubles. He's now tied for a team lead in home runs after Poppy's 2-run home run. 7 home runs, 33 RBIs, which leads Arkansas Monticello. There's the 1-2. Another one hit foul right at the Northwestern dugout. Do it again at 1-2. The Weevils again 20-17, 16-8 in conference. Been pretty good at home, 11-5. Not been bad on the road, 8-11. Trying to get back to close to 500 on the road this season. 1-2 pitch. That one got away from Stiles. They'll appeal. They're going to say he did not. Here's the throw down to second. It's not in time as Chase Cripps now going to be in scoring position.
Good base running there.
So the count evens up 2-2 now to Kirk Wolf. DeHaas checks the runner at second. Now rocks and fires, and that pitch swung on and missed for strike three, and that'll do it. And the first strikeout for Garrett DeHaas, but the damage is done as the Weevils do pick up Two runs on no hits, no errors, with one left on. Bottom of the first we go. Rangers do up when we come back. This is Northwestern Baseball brought to you by Holder Drug on the Ranger Sports Network.
Here at Bank Central, we like to shoot for three, and that includes our services to you. From fee-free checking accounts to competitive CD rates and all the way to consumer lending, stop by any of our locations in Alva, Enid, Woodward, and Cherokee, or call 580-327-1122 to talk with one of our qualified professionals. Bank Central, where we're centered on you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Certain fees and restrictions may apply.
You put in the work, and every day you go out and prove it again. You're an expert in your field. That's what farmers do every day. They go out and get the job done. If that's you, then Farm Credit of Western Oklahoma wants to thank you. For a livestock or crop loan, equipment loan, ag real estate, or operating loan, we will tailor a loan to your needs. Talk to one of our ag specialists by phone or stop by a branch today. Farm Credit of Western Oklahoma, an equal housing opportunity lender, online at farmcreditloans.com.
Welcome back to Myers Stadium as we head to the bottom of the first. Rangers trailing at 2-0 on the Community Bank scoreboard as we look at the starting pitcher today for Arkansas Monticello. And it will be the 6-foot junior out of Victoria, B.C., number 20, Connor Irvin. Irvin, again, 3.47 earned run average. He is 6-1. It'll be his 11th start. He's got one complete game, 59 and two-thirds, 55 hits, 26 runs, 23 of those earned. 18 walks to go along with 59 strikeouts, which is second on the team behind Charles Peacock. Teams are hitting .247 against Connor Irvin this season. Is the first baseman number 7, Dylan Bradford, will lead it off for Northwestern.
Third baseman in, just in case.
First pitch to Bradford from Irvin misses for ball one. Bradford, a .384 hitter, at second on the team. It's his 39th start of the season. 53 hits and 138 at bats. He's tied for a team lead in hits with Carson Wright as he takes it for 2-0. The right-hander Irvin ready to go with the 2-0 delivery. And here it is as Bradford looks at a called strike, counts 2-1. Bradford, of those 53 hits, 13 doubles, which leads the team, 3 triples, which also leads the team, 2 home runs and 19 RBIs. 2-1 to Bradford, just missed for ball 3. Count goes to 3-1. So 3 balls, 1 strike to Dylan Bradford.
I'm going to sit on my pitch right here.
That one's line foul to the left as the count goes full 3-2. Bradford followed by Carson Wright and Paul Sechin.
Just a little behind that pitch. Like to have it back. Good line drive pitch.
3-2. It's a ground ball hit to first. Fielded by Cancia. Flips to Irvin, who steps on first for out number one. And there's one down here in the top or bottom of the first inning.
Yeah, well covered by the pitcher there.
So now batting left fielder number 31, Carson Wright, who leads Northwestern in hitting .390 this season. His 39th start of the year. 53 hits for 136 at bats. He's also scored 35 runs on the year. As that pitch swung on and missed for strike one. 8 doubles, 2 triples, leading the team in home runs with 11. He's also leading the team in RBIs with 37. The Rangers in the top 10 in home runs hit this season with 58. That's 8th best in Division II as the count moves to 1-1.
He had a good cut at that first pitch.
And the 1-1. That's in there for a called strike. Count goes to 1-2 now. Irvin working quickly, ready to go with the 1-2 delivery. Swung on and missed for strike 3. And there's 2 down.
Good pitch. Looked like it dropped on him.
So the right fielder, Paul Sechin, now will bat. .267 hitter, 38 start, 35 hits and 131 at bats. 25 runs, 9 doubles, 1 triple, 5 home runs to go along with 29 RBIs this year. As Sechin looks at ball 1 as it was inside.
Infield's got a pretty big shift on him. Shortstop's on the first base side of the bag. Now he's moved back over to the third base side of the bag.
The 1-0. That one's lifted foul and out of play down the left as it gets out, and it actually hit that red truck parked out there.
I don't know if that was Rick Brown's truck or not.
Right off the hood. Here's the 1-1 pitch. That's a ground ball. Diving out on the was Kinsella. He'll flip to first, and that'll do it. On the 3-1 putout, and the Rangers go in order. No runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left on. Top of two we go after this. Rangers trailing at 2-0 on the Community Bank scoreboard. This is Northwestern Baseball, brought to you by Holder Drug on the Ranger Sports Network.
Get no better deal in the country than at Croft Country, located in Alva, Oklahoma. Croft Country is the dealer for vehicles in Northwest Oklahoma. Croft Country is locally owned and operated since 1985, offering a full line of award-winning brands including Chevy and GMC. From the time you enter our showroom for sales or service, you can expect to be treated like family. So the next time you're in the market for a new or used vehicle, come see us right here in Alva, located at 401 East Oklahoma Boulevard.
Anger, anxiety, worry, and disbelief. These are normal emotions to feel with an unplanned pregnancy. You have options, and you are not alone. Hope Pregnancy Center in Alva is a safe, confidential, and compassionate place to land. Hope offers free pregnancy testing and ultrasound, and you will be provided education for all your options. Remember, you aren't alone. We can help with Hope. Visit thinkimpregnant.org. That's thinkimpregnant.org.
To prevent medication from getting into the wrong hands, it is crucial to store it out of sight and out of the reach of children and visitors. In addition, it is important to dispose of unwanted, expired, and unused medications in a safe manner. For more information, visit okimready.org. That's okimready.org, or call 988 Oklahoma's Mental Health Lifeline. This program is funded by Northwestern Oklahoma State University, Oklahoma Department of Mental Health and Substance Abuse Prevention Services, and Substance Abuse Mental Health Services Administration.
Shortstop number 14, Aiden Garrett, will lead things off to open up play here in the top of the second as the first pitch to Garrett was strike one. That pitch misses outside. Count evens up 1-1 to Garrett. Garrett, a 280 hitter, 33rd start of the year, 28 hits and 100 at-bats this season. He's also scored 26 runs as he swings and the bat flies out of his hands. Count moves to 1-2, and I haven't seen that one in a while here at Meyer Stadium.
No, I haven't either.
So mark that on your bingo card.
Well, all the players today wear hitting gloves. And I don't know what kind of stickum they use. And so I would think it's pretty hard, to, you know, unlike yesteryear, let that ball or that bat out of your hands like that.
1-2 misses outside as the count moves to 2-2 now. To Aiden Garrett. Here's the 2-2 called strike three as Garrett looks at it. That's back-to-back strikeouts now for Garrett DeHaas, and there's one down.
That was a tough pitch right at the knees. Fastball.
As the third baseman, number 23, Brody Romero, will step in. 265 hitter, his 14th start, 13 hits and 49 at-bats this season. As Romero, well, that pitch missed. I was going to say he looks at strike one, but it was ball one. Here's the 1-0. That one's in there for a called strike, and I got to tell you, it looked like the same pitch.
Well, yeah, that other one was a whole 2 inches higher maybe. I'm sorry.
The 1-1 has popped up. Barcelo retreating back into shallow right center. He'll make the grab, and there's two down. Good to see Hagen back out there.
Yep. We've got that the infamous sun on the infield.
Now the DH, number 12, Logan Jones, will step in with two down, a 306 hitter. His 11th start, 11 hits and 36 at-bats. There's the pitch to Jones. That's in there for a called strike. Count is 0-1. So far, nice bounce back inning for Garrett DeHaas. And the 0-1. Fly ball lifted into left. Back is Carson Wright in front of the track. He'll make the grab. And the Weevils go in order in the second. No runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left on. Bottom of the second we go. Rangers trailing at 2-0 on the Community Bank scoreboard. This is Northwestern Baseball, brought to you by Holder Drug on the Ranger Sports Network.
When was the last time you evaluated your investment goals? With our ever-changing environment, it's time. Talk to us about locking in a high, long-term fixed interest rate and put your money to work for you. I'm Whitney Gum, and here at E&J Financial, we work with you to implement a custom plan to fit your financial goals. Call our office today at 580-327-2552 to book a complimentary financial review.
Securities offered through registered representatives of Cambridge Investment Research, member FINRA, SIPC. Advisory services offered through Cambridge Investment Research Advisors. Cambridge and E&J Financial are not affiliated.
K&S Tire in Alva has been locally owned and operated since 2004. While every business claims to be the best, K&S Tire is the best. Our satisfied customers speak for themselves by coming back to us each and every time. Our amazing services goes beyond a regular tune-up or tire rotation. Our team is well-trained and able to take care of all your car care needs, including preventative maintenance, wheel alignments, brakes, and more. Visit knstire.com for more information or come see us at 2590 College Boulevard right here in Alva.
The Tacoma Farmers Co-op is a proud supporter of Ranger and Gold Bug activities. Since 1916, they have been here to serve you with all your farming and ranching needs with a wide range of goods and services from fuel, hardware, fencing, tires, feed and seed, plus fertilizer. They're here to meet your needs. Choose to trade with a co-op that gives its profits back to you. To learn about the Tacoma Co-op Advantage, stop by one of five locations in Moreland, Freedom, Winoka, Jet, and Tacoma, or visit them at tacomacoop.com and get a better service at a better place.
The DH, Chad Green, will lead things off for the Rangers as he'll take ball one. Green, a 341 hitter, his 24th start. 30 hits and 88 at-bats, has also scored 14 runs this season for Northwestern. The 1-0 to Green is in there for a called strike. Count even so, 1-1 now to Chad Green.
Yeah, not the pitch you wanted. I mean, a couple of our hitters, pitchers are just going to stay outside on them.
1-1, that's a grounder down the third baseline. That is fair as that one got by the third baseman Romero. Goes all the way into the corner. Green's rounding first. He's headed for second. How about that? Leadoff double for Chad Green.
And a ground rule held up there at second, went underneath the fence there in that corner.
Yeah, it's always a tough spot down there in that left corner.
Yeah, there's a small gap, and he found it underneath that fence in the that one track turf.
So now to the plate, Hagan Barcelo. Barcelo, a 312 hitter, 37th start, 44 hits and 141 at-bats this season. Also scored 24 runs. As Barcelo looks at ball one, count moves to 1-0. Barcelo second on the team in doubles with 11. One triple, eight home runs, and 32 RBIs.
Get a bigger lead. Get a bigger lead. You got nobody holding you on.
Here's the 1-0. Fly ball lifted into right center. Going back is Hawthorne near the wall and makes the grab at the track. Green will tag up. He's headed for third. Here's the throw from the shortstop to third, and sliding in safely is Green, tagging up, and that moves the runner to third.
I'll take that. Now he's 90 feet from home with two outs to work with.
So now Trevor Sayre will step in. Of course, Sayre, the Great American Conference Player of the Week, hit over 700 last week for Northwestern, which is just almost unheard of. That's how you earn Conference Player of the Week.
Yeah.
Batting average now back up over 300, hitting 302 as he swings and misses there. Count is 0-1. 35th start for Sayre. 39 hits, 129 at-bats, has also scored 24 runs. Here's the 0-1. Just missed there. Count evens up, one ball, one strike.
Let's see if we can't get him home here this at-bat.
That pitch swung on and missed. Count moves to 1-2 now.
Well, that was right down the pipe, wasn't it? Or pipe. Anyway, dead center.
The 1-2 swung on and missed for strike three, and there's two down.
Now
to the plate will be Colby Grace. Big spot here. Runner 90 feet away with two down. Rangers trying to pick up their first run of the game. As Grace looks at a called strike, count is 0-1. Colby this season. 242 hitter, 37th start, 31 hits, 128 at-bats. 26 runs, 3 doubles, 9 home runs, which is second on the team in 25 RBIs. He's now down in the count 0-2.
The other pitcher's coming right at us, challenging us to hit his stuff.
Here's the 0-2 to Grace. Low and outside. Nice stop from Poppy behind home plate. Gap moves to 1-2 now. And you'd like to see the Rangers again. Had the leadoff double, and then Barcelo moved a run to the third. Sayers struck out. Get us to 2 down. 1-2 pitch. Upstairs for ball 2. Count evens up 2-2 now.
Well, you know you're going to get a good pitch against this pitcher. He's a little up.
Just a little bit high. 3-2 now on the breaking ball. Of course, other Great American Conference action going on. We'll keep you updated on those games as well. 3-2 to Grace. That one's hit off the end of the bat right to first. Fielding that will be Cancia. He'll step on first, and that'll do it as the Rangers squander a runner at third here in the second. No runs on one hit, no errors with one left on. We move into the third. Rangers trailing at 2-0 on the Community Bank scoreboard. This is Northwestern Baseball brought to you by Holder Drug on the Rangers Sports Network.
Naloxone is a medication designed to rapidly reverse opioid overdose. A person who is experiencing an overdose can't administer naloxone to themselves. Anyone can carry naloxone, give it to someone experiencing an overdose, and potentially save a life. That's why everyone should consider having naloxone. For more information, visit okimready.org. That's okimready.org. This program is funded by Northwestern Oklahoma State University, Oklahoma Department of Mental Health and Substance Abuse Prevention Services, and Substance Abuse Mental Health Services Administration.
818 Diner has consistently provided the city of Alva with quality comfort food and great service since opening in 2019. Join us for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. Some of our popular menu items to choose from include the BCB Burger, the French Dip, and our staples such as Terry's Chicken Fried Steak, Don's Hamburger Steak, and Joe's Chicken Tenders. Open Monday and Wednesday through Sunday from 6 a.m. to 2 p.m. and open for dinner Wednesday through Friday, 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. So if you want a variety of menu items and friendly service to give you that local diner feeling, visit 818 Diner right here in Alva.
Dean Gall Real Estate and Auction has been serving clients in Oklahoma and Kansas for nearly 37 years. If you're looking to buy, sell, or invest, we are your real estate professionals. We will get you the top dollar for your property, whether it be at auction or private sale. Get with Dean Gall Real Estate and Auction if you're wanting to buy a ranch, good farmland, sell or lease minerals, or buy a home. Visit our website at deangallauction.com to browse available listing. Talk to Dean, Steve, or Todd at 580-327-8217 or stop by the office in Alva, where you're always greeted with a smile. Come and see us.
Center fielder number one, Rock Hawthorne, will lead it off as we're back to the top of the order. He hits a ground ball back up the middle through for a base hit. And it's a leadoff single for Hawthorne, and the Weevils have a base runner to open up the third. It's now their second hit of the game.
Nice easy swing, just put the bat on the ball and boom, right up the middle.
Now to the plate, Camden Tanner, who walked and scored a run back in the first off that two-run home run hit by Chaz Poppy. Left-handed batter, Tanner will step in. First pitch by DeHaas, fly ball lifted into center. Back goes Sayre. He will stop, camp underneath it, make the grab, and there's one down.
That was a big out.
See if the Rangers can maybe turn two here and get out of this thing.
Yeah, I was envisioning the count getting to a particular spot and then doing a hit and run because he's a contact hitter.
So now Cade Cancia now will hit. He's 0 for 1 today. Popped out in foul territory down the right field line. It was caught by Bradford. Rangers again have turned 30 double plays so far this season as Cancia takes a called strike count as 0-1.
No signs from the third base coach.
There's the 0-1. That one's just a bit up. Count evens up. One ball, one strike. Here's the throw back over. Getting back safely is Hawthorne.
Caught him on the lane there, didn't he?
Certainly did. Throwing over once more. Hawthorne gets back.
Doesn't have a big lead, but
1-1 pitch. Just missed there as the count moves to 2-1.
You know, again, I used to be an umpire, but it seems like some of these pitches are breaking balls or not getting the call.
Here's the 2-1. Runner had acted like he was going to go. Here's the throw back down to first. Hawthorne does get back as the count goes to 3-1, though.
We need to get the hitter here.
Henderson State leading Southern Nazarene. They're in the fifth in Bethany. It's 5-1 Reddies. Three-one pitch, and it's ball four. Runner's now going to be at first and second as a runner in scoring position now for the Weevils, just one out. And, of course, the dangerous Chaz Poppy will step into the batter's box. Already 1-for-1 today, had a two-run home run to left back in the first.
Now batting catcher, Chaz Poppy.
Zadehaus trying to work out of a jam. Runners on first and second, just one out, top of the third. As that one just low and outside for ball one.
Infield fly rule in effect.
Here's the 1-0. Swung on and missed for strike one as DeHaas blew that one by him. Count evens up 1-1.
Yeah, kind of. Some of these guys just stay outside of their strength, so keep them on the outside part of the plate, make them try to go to the opposite field.
1-1 pitch. That's in there for a called strike as Poppy kind of checked his swing, didn't go around, and he thought that one was a ball. Here's the 1-2. DeHaas checks the runner at second. Here it is. Up and in for ball two. Count evens up. Two balls, two strikes to Chaz Poppy.
Yeah. So are we going to set up inside on him or outside? Inside.
High chopper. Hit to short, 6-4. Here's to three. Can the Rangers turn it? And they do. So a 6-4-3 double play hits the Rangers out of the jam.
Barcelo made a really good adjustment because Wilshire's toss was just about shoulder high. So Hagen, I think, got a two-touch on it. He got it over really good.
So Rangers turn a double play for the 31st time this season. And that'll end the inning in the top of the third. No runs on one hit, no errors. One left on. We head to the bottom of the third inning. Rangers trailing at 2-0 on the Community Bank scoreboard. This is Northwestern Baseball brought to you by Holder Drug on the Rangers Sports Network.
Spring is here and so are the savings at G&G Home Furnishings in Alva. Right now it's our annual anniversary sale happening through the month of April. Mattresses starting at $299, Lazy Boy recliners at $499, sofas at $399, dining room sets at $599, and bedroom sets starting at just $329. Don't miss out on all the savings throughout the month of April, so stop in and browse during our anniversary sale happening at G&G Home Furnishings, located at 2107 College Boulevard, right here in Alva.
Looking for the best in lawn care? Peak Environment has you covered. We offer a wide range of services, including full-service mowing, weed control, Christmas light installation, and more. Peak Environment provides efficient and affordable services across Northwest Oklahoma with branches in Alva, Enid, and Woodward. Call our office today at 580-748-8003 for a free quote on any service. That's Peak Environment, 748-8003. Proud supporter of all Ranger and Gold Bug Athletics.
The Alva Moose Lodge is a proud supporter of all Northwestern and Alva public school activities and strives to be the heart of the community through fundraisers and community-based events that make a difference in the lives of individuals, kids, and families throughout Northwest Oklahoma. On a national basis, the Moose Fraternity provides at-risk children with a second chance at life and its senior members a comforting retirement at its five-star senior facility in Florida. If you would like to see how you can help make a difference in the lives of those in need, stop by the Alva Moose Lodge Monday through Saturday from 4 p.m. to 10:30 p.m. at 302 7th Street to learn more.
Catcher number 20, Trevor Stiles, will lead things off for the Rangers as we move to the bottom of the third inning. Northwestern trailing 2-0 as the first pitch was swung on and missed, and then he looks at strike two as Stiles behind the count 0-2 now. Stiles, a 340 hitter, his 18th start, 18 hits and 53 at-bats, has also scored 13 runs this season. 0-2 pitch, that one's going outside for ball one. Trevor Stiles followed by Jacob Wiltshire, and back to the top of the order with Dylan Bradford due up for the Rangers. Here's the 1-2, swung on and missed for strike three, third strikeout issued by Irvin, and there's one down. Irvin now give him 62 strikeouts on the season. The shortstop, Jacob Wiltshire, steps into the batter's box. 248 hitter, 39th start, 28 hits, 113 at-bats this season. That one caught the outside corner for a called strike. Count moves to 0-1.
Yeah, Dr. Mark and Audra in the house here with the kiddos.
0-1 misses up. Count evens up 1-1. It's good to see former Ranger baseball players out making it to the park.
Yeah.
1-1 pitch. Swung on and missed for strike two as the count moves to 1-2 now.
Zadorozny. I expect we'll see Shane Hansen out here sometime today.
1-2 pitch, that's a fly ball hit hard into right. Retreating back will be Camden Tanner. He'll make the grab, and there's two down. Rangers trying to avoid going in order. They did so in the first. We're back to the top of the order, though, with Dylan Bradford, who grounded out to first last time up.
Now batting for Rangers, first baseman Dylan Bradford.
Again, bottom of the third, Rangers trailing at 2-0. It's game one of our three-game series this weekend. First pitch to Bradford. He'll look at a called strike. Count will be 0-1.
Down dugout club, I saw Mr. Terry Ross is in town up north. And of course, Pat Harkins here, Dr. Brown, Ken Brown.
I've seen Terry in a while.
And Dr. Brown, I asked him if that ball hit Rick's truck, and he said it did. It left a dent about the size of a baseball.
Yeah. 1-1 to Bradford. Caught the outside corner. Count moves to 1-2. That was harsh. One ball, two strikes to Dylan Bradford. And the delivery.
Yeah.
That's a line shot down the right field line. That's down for a hit. As Tanner will throw it back in, but it's a two-out single for Dylan Bradford. First hit of the game for the Rangers. And they've got a base runner. Second hit of the game.
Just turned on it, smooth swing, making contact, not trying to drive it out of the park, just trying to get on.
So Carson Wright to the plate. He's 0-for-1 today. He struck out last time up. One of three strikeouts for Irvin today. First pitch to Wright. That's in there. Boy, I thought that was a little low, but the count moves to 0-1.
Yeah, I've seen him call a couple of low fastballs. That was outside corner and the knees.
There's the 0-1. Yeah. That's a line drive into right center. That's down for a base hit. Bradford turns and, well, made the turn at second and then kind of stumbled, and he'll have to retreat back to second, just getting back ahead of the throw from Hawthorne to the tag from Garrett.
Check to see if he's all right. I guess, I don't know. Darn turf.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Yeah, Coach Bowen will come out and check on his first baseman, Dylan Bradford. Well, yeah, Bradford doesn't stumble there. You're talking about runners at the corners and putting the bat in the hands of Paul Sachin. But
well, and he still had time to take third, but I think he was a little disoriented or shook or something.
Yeah, because Hawthorne kind of, you know, it a little bit out
there behind
center.
Him, yeah.
So it seems Bradford is okay as Coach Bowen heads back to the dugout. So Paul Sachin will step in. Of course, if you're out there listening, come on out to the ballpark today. Free snow cones right now for anybody who makes it out there. We'll have hot dogs and brats later on this evening. Runners at first and second. Here's the delivery to Sachin off the end of the bat. Down the third baseline, just rolled foul as the count moves to 0-1.
Oh, that was a squibber. You couldn't tell what that was going to do. You know, I was thinking, oh, gosh, our fortune, that thing's going to go fair, and the third baseman is just going to catch it right at the bag and say, thank you. But it was a few inches foul. Again, you know, and he will kind of stay away from Station, his power. So might look for another ball to drive to left field here while he's at bat.
There's the 0-1. Up and away for ball one. Count evens up, one ball, one strike to Sachin, who it was 0-for-1 today. Grounded out to first, back in the first.
I'd like to see us get a bigger lead at the bags. Make the pitcher think right now we're no threat.
Here's the 1-1. That one misses up high for ball two to Sachin. Two balls, one strike to Paul Sachin.
I mean, even when the pitcher comes set, he looks back at you. I mean, break. Break for the bag. Third base, I mean. You know, try to get in his head a little bit. See if we can't get this ball four or a fat pitch.
Ball 2-1. Make it 3-1 now to Sachin. If Sachin is takes here, he'll be swinging. Irvin checks the runner at second. Here's the 3-1. That one's fouled back to the net. Count goes full now, 3-2.
Good fastball. Again, I want to fake a steal right here from the runner. I'm going to get in the pitcher's head.
3-2 pitch. Runners will take off, and it's ball four. So bases are loaded as Bradford to third, Carson Wright to second, Sachin to first as they put the bat into the hands of Chad Green, who doubled. Last time up. And a ground ball all the way into the left corner. So big spot here. They sit here would tie the game. Here's the pitch to Green. That's in there for a called strike. Count is 0-1.
All this with two outs. See if we can't do some damage here.
0-1 pitch. Ground ball hit the left side. Is through for a base hit. One run will come in to score. Heading for home is Carson Wright. Here's the throw in. It's wide. And Carson Wright slides in safely. And driving in two with a single is Chad Green as the game is now tied at two.
Boy, I had the shortstop shaded towards third base side, too. And that ball just squirted between third baseman and shortstop like a seeing eye grounder.
And yeah, Romero dove out for it but just could not get to it. Rangers still with an opportunity to make some noise here in the third, as there's runners at first and second as Barcelo steps in.
He struggled in the count a little bit, so don't chase. Make him earn it.
Barcelo, that's blown away for ball one.
Of course, we know Hagan gets his arm extended. He can make this a three-run shot.
1-0 pitch, low it off the plate. Count moves to 2-0 now.
But he's laboring a little bit. Catcher's going out to visit. So, you know, we need to be patient at the plate and take advantage when it's proper.
Chad Poppy out to have a word with Irvin. Again, score tied at 2. As the Rangers have picked up 3 hits here in the third so far. Home plate umpire will go out now. As Poppy hits back to home plate.
I think said something about, well, there'll be brats and hot dogs a little bit later.
Yeah.
So, I mean, focus on that.
I definitely will be. We'll have that pizza up here, a little, nice little buffet. 2-0 pitch is low and outside for ball three.
Well,
again, as you mentioned, all this being done with two outs, Irvin got the first two hitters.
Yeah.
3-0 is in there for a called strike. Count goes 3-1.
Yeah, Coach Bowen just gave him that pump sign. Drive it. Throws another fat here. He's going to launch it.
3-1 pitch, and there it is. That is crushed into left center, going back towards the walls. It sails over for a 3-run home run by Hagan Barcelo, and the Rangers now lead it 5-2. I believe you just called that, didn't you?
I did. That's, you know, that's just totally lucky. He's, you know, but
you pre-call a home run.
I just know he's a, you know, he's a player, and he knew what he was looking for.
Boy, you mentioned if you're Irvin, he just served that one up, and Barcelo was ready for it.
Yep.
So just like that, the Rangers now lead it 5-2 as Trevor Serre will bat his. He'll take strike one, count as 0-1, and Irvin now has really struggled here in the third.
But we know this game's not going to end 5-2.
That's exactly right. Here's the 0-2 pitch. That's a ground ball back up the middle through for a base hit as Garrett couldn't get to it. And a single from Trevor Serre. And, boy, the Rangers right now tagging Irvin. And I'm surprised they have not gone out to go visit with him. And, well, as I say that, they're headed out there now. This mound visit brought to you by G&G Home Furnishings.
Well, they're getting some... You know, we got at-bats, and we've got quality at-bats. We're getting quality at-bats right now.
Let's take a 30-second break for the visit. This is Northwestern Baseball, brought to you by Holder Drug on the Ranger Sports Network.
Keeping your car clean is an inexpensive way to protect its value. Shirley Shine Car Wash, located west of Love, offers a 6-bay self-serve car wash, including 3 truck bays. Your wash options include soap, tire cleaner, foamy brush, wax, spot-free rinse, and air chamois. And you can pay with credit, debit card, or quarters. Don't just clean the outside, clean the inside with its self-serve car vacuum. You can also clean your pet with their self-serve dog wash. Company vehicle? Be sure to ask about our fleet account. So the next time your vehicle needs rinse or detailed, come by Shirley Shine Car Wash, located right here in Alva.
Mound visit appears to be over. That mound visit, again, brought to you by G&G Home Furnishings. Is Irvin ready to go? Is Rangers again with another hit here in this inning. That is hit number 4. Of course, one of those, a 3-run home run by Barcelo to give the Rangers a lead as Colby Grace steps in, who's 0-1 today. Grace will take strike one, count as 0-1. And again, this started, Trevor Stiles struck out, Wiltshire flew into right, and then it was a hit, a single, a walk, a single, and then a 3-run home run.
Yep.
Here's the 0-1.
Goodbye.
That is crushed into right center by Grace, back towards the wall, and it is gone again. Colby Grace with a 2-run home run. Second home run inning for the Rangers, and it's now 7-2.
You know what I liked about that one? He didn't try to pull it. He just wanted to meet it where it was pitched. And it went out just right of center. Got his arms extended. Didn't try to take it to left field. Just hit it where it was.
How quickly this game has changed. As it's 7-2 now, Northwestern. A 3-run home run and a 2-run home run as Trevor Stiles will now bat. First pitch to Stiles, misses for ball one.
Again, make the pitcher work. You know, don't be jumping on just anything.
Stiles swings and misses there. Count evens up 1-1. Rangers have now hit 60 home runs on the season. Here's the 1-1. Swung on and missed for strike two. Count moves to 1-2. And you know, one thing I talked about with Coach Bone is how well they hit the ball, but Northwestern does a good job of manufacturing runs at times, too. We can also lay down some bunts.
Yeah.
That pitch swung on and missed for strike three, and that'll do it. For the Rangers in the third, but, boy, Northwestern, what an inning for the Rangers as they pick up 7 runs on 6 hits, no errors, with nobody left on. We head to the fourth. This game has changed dramatically. Rangers lead it 7-2 on the Community Bank scoreboard. This is Northwestern Baseball, brought to you by Holder Drug on the Ranger Sports Network.
At Ignite Physical Therapy, we assist in the therapy of many different aspects, such as advanced problem solving, joint mobilization, treatment of adverse neural tension, evaluation and treatment of muscle imbalance, tissue-specific exercise, and patient education. Dr. Jared Haida and staff want to get you back to the life that you had before your injury. They have helped so many through rehabilitation, and they can do the same for you. Stop by and see the staff at Ignite Physical Therapy on 520 Glen Street or make an appointment by calling 580-327-3331.
We know how much love your pet gives you. We're Ridgeview Veterinary Hospital. We're always here for you and your pet. Ridgeview Vet Hospital provides the most comprehensive care from regular checkups to emergency. Ridgeview Vet Hospital proudly provides veterinary services to all animals, large or small. Visit us today to let Dr. Lohman and his staff take care of your extended family located right here in Alva, or call us to schedule your appointment at 580-327-0201. Ridgeview Vet Hospital is a proud supporter of Alva and Northwestern activities.
Your agency of choice for all types of insurance is McDermott Insurance in Alva. For home, auto, farm, or business insurance, the McDermott Agency will protect what you value most by providing the best coverage and client service possible. To get your custom professional insurance review, call McDermott Insurance at 580-327-3500 or visit them at 526 Flynn Street in Alva. McDermott Insurance. They can't predict the future, but they can insure it.
Second baseman number 9, Chase Cripps, will lead it off for the Weevils as we open up play, top of the fourth. As the 0-1 is inside, count evens up 1-1. It'll be Chase Cripps followed by Kirk Wolf and Aiden Garrett. For Arkansas Monticello, Rangers lead it now 7-2 after picking up 7 runs in the third as DeHaas delivers low for ball two. Here's the 2-1. That is ripped foul. It's just out in front of that. Grips. That was all the way. That one got well up into the parking lot.
Yeah, that may have made it to that one smaller maintenance shed up there.
2-2. That's down the right field line in the air as that will land in foul territory. Sachin not able to get to that one. Count evens up 2-2 now as we start to see action of the bullpen for Arkansas Monticello. They do have a right hand up.
Yeah, DeHaas, just keep throwing strikes here. Don't let it go 3-2.
2-2 pitch, swung on a miss for strike three, and there's one down to start things here in the fourth. Third strikeout for Garrett DeHaas. Out of the plate to left fielder number 19, Kirk Wolf. He's 0-for-1 today. One of the three strikeouts issued by Garrett DeHaas. That pitch in for ball one. I was fully expecting that to be called a ball.
Garrett's kind of got a confidence on his motions now.
That's a fly ball lifted foul down the right field line as it gets out of play, and Kirk Wolf quickly behind 0-2.
He is on top of the hitters now. Like his delivery sped up just a little bit too.
Working quickly, the 0-2 pitch and a grounder hit foul towards the Northwestern dugout. We'll do it again. No balls, two strikes. And one thing we hadn't talked about, the Rangers again, and of course the official regional rankings don't come out, I think, for another week or two. As there's a line driving a right center down for a base hit. That's in the gap as rounding first, heading for second is Kirk Wolf. As that one rolls all the way to the wall, throw back in by Sachin, but it's a one-out double from Kirk Wolf.
Well, that was a good hit.
So Wolf doubles for the ninth time this season as Aiden Garrett will bat. But in the Central Region media poll, Rangers again tied for sixth with Pittsburgh State. Arkansas Monticello was receiving votes, and then two other polls. In the top 25, Rangers were receiving votes in the D2 Baseball Insider, and then, of course, the other poll, the ABCA, Rangers receiving votes in that poll as well.
Is there a barber poll, too? I mean, how many polls are there?
You're right. Oh, there's a long fly ball into right center going back is towards the wall, and that one sails over the fence for another home run for Arkansas Monticello, a two-run shot by Aiden Garrett. And just like that, it's 7-4.
That wasn't a mistake pitch either. I mean, he went down and drove it, went down and got it.
So Aiden Garrett homers for the fifth time this season, giving 20 RBIs.
Yeah, we're going to have a visit, Coach Pickford.
So Coach Pickford will go out for the mound visit, brought to you by G&G Home Furnishings. Let's take a 30-second break and come back. This is Northwestern Baseball, brought to you by Holder Drug on the Ranger Sports Network.
Alva Health and Wellness is Alva's newest healthcare option, offering a broad array of services geared to address today's most common illnesses and injuries. Alva Health and Wellness offers services for you and your child, including sickness, wellness, chronic care management, vaccinations, weight loss, and so much more. Find more information online by visiting alvahealthandwellness.com or come by and make an appointment with Jeremy Logsdon in person at 515 College Avenue right here in Alva.
Welcome back to Meyer Stadium. There's one out here in the top half of the fourth. Cripps struck out and then double from Wolf and then a two-run shot by Aiden Garrett to right center has gotten the Weevils back within three. It's 7-4. One out here in the top of the fourth is the third baseman. Romero will step in. First pitch is swung and a miss for strike one to Romero.
Took a little something off of that one. And again. Oh, come on. I'm going
to say that one just missed to Brody Romero. Count evens up 1-1. Who's 0-for-1 today. Popped out to second last time up. 1-1 pitch is hit foul by Romero. Count moves to 1-2. Well, so far we've had four home runs hit today. Two by each team. Weevils with two-run home runs. Rangers with a two-run home run and a three-run home run. 1-2 pitch. Call, strike three, and that's the fourth strikeout by Romero. Or excuse me, by DeHaas as Romero strikes out looking.
That's a good pitch. Like that slider at the knees in the outside corner.
As the DH, Logan Jones will hit. He flew out to left last time up. He's 0-for-1 today. First pitch to Jones. Just a bit high and in for ball one.
I got my basketball, Jones. Was that Cheech and Chong?
And the 1-0 jump foul. Count evens up. That one actually went back off of Jones. Count evens up 1-1.
And me and Mrs. Jones, that was a great song back in the 60s. See Myra Davison out here today in shorts.
Boy, this is a ball lifted into left again. This one to right. He'll camp underneath it, make the grab, and that'll do it for the Weevils here in the top of the fourth as they pick up two runs on two hits, no errors, with nobody left on. Bottom of the fourth we go. Rangers lead at 7-4 on the Community Bank scoreboard. This is Northwestern Baseball brought to you by Holder Drug on the Ranger Sports Network.
Don't miss the Monster Truck Spring Nationals. One giant show this Saturday, 8 p.m. Crystal Beach Stadium, Woodward, Oklahoma. See the baddest trucks on the planet in ground-pounding, car-crushing action, including Animal House, driven by the world's youngest female driver. She's only 15 years old. She'll take on Dysfunctional, Kicking and Screaming, Redneck Rampage, and Sergeant Smash. Don't miss the Oklahoma Tough Truck Contest, where locals run for cash. Special VIP box seats and pit passes, including attendance to the pre-show pit party. It's with trucks, autographs, and kids meet Batman. Plus a superhero souvenir. You can even take a ride in a real monster truck. Tickets available at United Grocery, Napa, Cowboy Tech Shop, Woodward Steel, at the gate, or online at showclix.com. Sponsored by Advanced Real Estate Advisors and Cool Brothers Collision, Northwestern Electric Co-op, K&S Tire, Red Prairie, SPC, Red Dirt Gun and Pawn, and Great Plains Bank. Monster Truck Spring National this Saturday. Woodward, be there.
Welcome back to Glass Family Field at Meyer Stadium. Dustin Goodwill alongside Steve Barrows. We move to the bottom of the fourth inning as Jacob Wiltshire will lead it off for the Rangers as we're here at the bottom at the Orb. Wiltshire 0-for-1 today, flew out to right last time up.
You know, I commented about Myra Davison wearing shorts. Well, you and I are both wearing shorts. It's a shorts day. There's a lot of people out there in shorts.
Wiltshire fouls this one off the bat. That'll be in foul territory. And giving chase and not able to make the grab as Cancia had it in his glove and it popped out. So it'll just be strike one.
Yeah, Pete liked that one back. I even broke out my Chacos.
I saw that.
Yeah. I don't even know how old they are now. Been on many a canoe trips and hiking and trails.
There's the 0-1, just missed outside off the corner. Count evens up 1-1 strike to Wiltshire.
Wilshire, you want to kind of get on base here.
1-1 is in there for a called strike as the count goes to 1-2 now.
Staying outside on him. But when you get a second life like he does, now you want to take advantage of it, get on base somehow.
1-2 from Irvin. That's outside as well. Count evens up 2-2 now. Rangers with 7 runs on 7 hits. The Weevils, 4 runs on 4 hits. Neither team has committed an error to this point. It's the 2-2 upstairs for ball 3. Irvin does have 1 walk so far. Came again to Sachin back in the 3rd.
For that outside pitch, you're going to have to guard the plate.
3-2, that's lined to the first baseman. Making the grab is Cancia for the first out on the liner. And there's one down here in the bottom of the 4th. Kind of right off the end of the bat.
Yeah.
So now Dylan Bradford will step into the batter's box. 1-for-2 today. Grounded out to first in the 1st, singled and scored a run in the 3rd. As that one's hit inside as he's jammed, and Irvin will tag out Bradford, and there's 2 down.
Yeah, I thought maybe it hit his foot or something.
I did too. That's kind of, I thought he was going to retreat back, but he took off for first. The umpire didn't stop it, so. That was quickly 2 down. That was on the first pitch.
Now we'll get a video look at it again.
Well, that's what I think Coach Bowen is saying, that he thought it hit him.
And then, do you question Bradford for taking off, or do you just stay there, kind of act like you got hit? But if the umpires, if an umpire can't see it, he can't call it.
That's right. So now Carson Wright will bat with 2 down here in the bottom of the 4th. Low and outside for ball 1 to Carson Wright.
Yeah, I immediately thought it hit his foot when it came off his bat.
And the 1-0 is a breaking ball for a called strike. Count evens up 1-1 to Wright.
Carson, this is where we began our rally last inning, so, you know.
It was, again, with 2 down. Here's the 1-1. That one misses low. 2-1 to Carson Wright, who's 1-for-2 today. Struck out in the 1st, singled and scored a run in the 3rd. Here's the 2-1. That's into right center in the gap. That's going to get down for a base hit. 1 hop off the wall. Wright's headed for 2nd, and this will be a 2-out double for Carson Wright, his 2nd hit of the game, and a runner in scoring position for the Rangers.
Nice piece of hitting there. The barrel down on it. Now Sachin up. And
so now to the plate, Paul Sachin. Grounded out to 1st, back in the 1st, walked and scored a run in the 3rd. Let's see if Sachin can come up with his 1st hit of today and drive in Carson Wright.
It's 82 degrees out.
Nice warm day.
Yep. Tomorrow warmer.
First pitch to Sachin as a breaking ball for ball 1.
Sunday, I think, is supposed to be 118. It's going to hit the mid-90s, I believe.
That's what it's going to feel like after all this nice weather we've had. Here's the 0-1. And swung on a miss for strike 2 as Sachin chased that one low. So Sachin quickly behind in the count 0-2 now.
Yeah, right now, change your thinking. You got to guard the plate and put it in play. Something can happen from it. Long set.
0-2 pitch. Swung on and missed for strike 3, and that'll do it for the Rangers here in the 4th. As the Rangers do not get any back. No runs on 1 hit. No errors with 1 left on. Top of the 5th we go. Rangers lead at 7-4 on the Community Bank scoreboard. This is Northwestern Baseball brought to you by Holder Drug on the Rangers Sports Network.
Alva State Bank and Trust Company, older than Oklahoma. Big enough to serve you and small enough to know you.
We love to give back to our customers. Did you know Alva State Bank offers a great rewards checking account program?
That's right. You can earn cash back or high interest with our Kasasa accounts. We will even refund you up to $25 in ATM fees.
How do I qualify?
It's simple. Just swipe your debit card 12 times, sign up for online statements, and have one ACH credit or debit post to your account.
Can I do it online?
Yes. Just visit our website at www.alvastatebank.com to see if our Kasasa Rewards program is right for you.
We make banking easy. Whether you're at home, the office, or in your car, our online or mobile banking options help you juggle busy schedules and financial needs.
We plant roots where others have branches.
Equal housing lender, member FDIC. Holder Drug has been serving the community of Alva since 1952. When you are in need of medication, healthcare items, and more, look to none other than Holder Drug, Alva's local pharmacy. Holder Drug is locally and family-owned and is always ready to serve you. They offer convenient drive-through pickup as well as free delivery with your medication. They also offer a number of gift ideas for those special holidays. For more information, visit their website, www.holderdrug.com, or stop by 513 Barnes Avenue in downtown Alva.
Top of the fifth we go as the center fielder, Rock Hawthorne, will lead it off. He's behind in the count, 0-2.
Yeah, home plate umpire thought he called that a strike, thinking he swung.
0-2 pitch. And this is low for ball one. It'll be Hawthorne followed by Camden Tanner and Cade Kinsia. Hawthorne 1-for-2 today, singled in his last at-bat back in the third, got it out to second in the first as he looks at ball two. Count evens up 2-2 now.
Rock Hawthorne. Sounds like an actor's
Hollywood
name.
It certainly does.
Starring Rock Hawthorne.
And upstairs for ball three. And again, count's gone full now, 3-2 after Hawthorne was down 0-2. You want to avoid putting the leadoff runner on. And it swung on and missed for strike three. Fifth strikeout for DeHaas.
I'm not sure what kind of pitch that was. He doesn't have a wiffle ball pitch. I couldn't tell what that thing did. It danced a little bit.
Certainly did. Hawthorne not ready for that one at all. As Camden Tanner will now bat, he's 0-for-1 today. Walked and scored a run in this first. Flew out to center in the third. Again, it's 7-4 Northwestern. As Tanner looks at a called strike. 66 pitches now thrown by Garrett DeHaas. And the 0-1. Grounder hit to second. Barcelo lays out for it. Fields throws to first on a 4-3 putout. And there's two down. Nice play there.
Yeah, it really was. You hope that it wasn't jarring to him, but it was it was like a slide pop-up and throw.
Looks like some of our Ranger men's basketball team has made their way out here to Meyer Stadium.
Cancel up.
So Gabe Cancia will now hit 0-for-1 today. It walked last time up as Haas delivers a cold strike, counts 0-1.
Yeah, there's quite a few people out here and more coming, and it's like starting to set up the bull.
The 0-1 misses low. Count evens up, 1-1. Oh, yeah, free food. Students come running, right?
Well, I know a lot of the community do, too.
That's true, yeah. Here's the 1-1. Breaking balls in there for a called strike. Count goes 1-2 now.
Well, Winnets have great products, and the bull, they don't put out anything that isn't great.
Here's the 1-2 pitch. High chopper hit foul on the third base line. Count will stay at 1-2 now. Again, we're in the top of the fifth. Rangers on top, 7-4. Weevil's got 2 in the first, 2 in the fourth. Rangers come up with 7 in the third. That's where we stand here in the top of the fifth. 1-2 pitch. Just off the end of the bat. As you can see, it stays alive.
Yeah, you can see him kind of extend those arms just to get a piece of that thing as it went by him.
Here's the 1-2. Grounder hit to first. Bradford will field. He'll flip. And covering is DeHaas, and that'll do it. As the Weevils go in order for the first time here this afternoon. No runs, no hits, no errors. Nobody left on. Bottom of the fifth we go. Rangers lead at 7-4 on the Community Bank scoreboard. It's Northwestern Baseball, brought to you by Holder Drug on the Ranger Sports Network 105.7.
Community Bank has been serving Alva, Oklahoma, and the surrounding area since 1984. Community Bank was founded by local community members who wanted to ensure the banking needs of the community were being met. It has been our goal since inception to provide customer-focused services and community development. Our customers are friends, neighbors, and never just a number. We believe in investing in our community, and we pride ourselves in being your hometown bank. Community Bank, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
Do you need assistance taking care of yourself or a loved one? Beatles Nursing Home in Alva is here for you. We offer safe, high-quality, affordable nursing care while meeting all care guidelines for living. Call us at 580-327-1274 to learn more about our admissions process to place your loved one in our care. When it's time to choose a nursing home facility, we'll hope you'll consider Beatles Nursing Home, located at 916 Noble Street in Alva.
Here at Bank Central, we like to shoot for three, and that includes our services to you. From fee-free checking accounts to competitive CD rates and all the way to consumer lending, stop by any of our locations in Alva, Enid, Woodward, and Cherokee, or call 580-327-1122 to talk with one of our qualified professionals. Bank Central, where we're centered on you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Certain fees and restrictions may apply.
The DH, number 55, Chad Green, will step into the batter's box to lead things off here in the bottom of the fifth as he comes out to a little Def Leppard for you. Green had a good day at the plate so far. Doubled in the second. Had a two RBI single in the third. He's also scored a run in the third.
Yeah. See if he can table set.
The 1-0 is a breaking ball upstairs. Make it 2-0 now to Chad Green. He'll be followed by Hagen Barcelo and Trevor Sayre. And this is the part of the order that did a lot of the damage for the Rangers in the third. They scored 7 as Green looks at ball 3.
A little bit low. Yeah, I'm going to make him throw me 1 for sure. Second one, I'm going to go ahead and give him the green.
3-0 pitch. Upstairs for ball 4 on 4 straight pitches, and it's a leadoff walk for Chad Green as he reaches base safely in all 3 at-bats so far.
Well, Mrs. Elda Jones is here. Former instructor at Northwestern. Dr. Carmichael, you have to be listening or watching. How are you?
Marcelo 1-for-2 today, flew out to center in the second, had that 3-run bomb in the third as we're going to get a visit to the mound, brought to you by G&G Home Furnishings, and I think we're going to see a new pitcher as well for the Weevils. We'll talk about the new pitcher in this call, the bullpen, brought to you by Ignite Physical Therapy right after this. This is Northwestern Baseball, brought to you by Holder Drug on the Ranger Sports Network.
You put in the work, and every day you go out and prove it again. You're an expert in your field. That's what farmers do every day. They go out and get the job done. If that's you, then Farm Credit of Western Oklahoma wants to thank you. For a livestock or crop loan, equipment loan, ag real estate, or operating loan, we will tailor a loan to your needs. Talk to one of our ag specialists by phone or stop by a branch today. Farm Credit of Western Oklahoma and Equal Housing Opportunity Lender, online at farmcreditloans.com.
Get no better deal in the country than at Croft Country, located in Alva, Oklahoma. Croft Country is the dealer for vehicles in Northwest Oklahoma. Croft Country is locally owned and operated since 1985, offering a full line of award-winning brands including Chevy and GMC. From the time you enter our showroom for sales or service, you can expect to be treated like family. So the next time you're in the market for a new or used vehicle, come see us right here in Alva, located at 401 East Oklahoma Boulevard.
Anger, anxiety, worry, and disbelief. These are normal emotions to feel with an unplanned pregnancy. You have options, and you are not alone. Hope Pregnancy Center in Alva is a safe, confidential, and compassionate place to land. Hope offers free pregnancy testing and ultrasound, and you will be provided education for all your options. Remember, you aren't alone. We can help with Hope. Visit thinkimpregnant.org. That's thinkimpregnant.org.
To prevent medication from getting into the wrong hands, it is crucial to store it out of sight and out of the reach of children and visitors. In addition, it is important to dispose of unwanted, expired, and unused medications in a safe manner. For more information, visit okimready.org That's OKIMREADY.org or call 988 Oklahoma's Mental Health Lifeline. This program is funded by Northwestern Oklahoma State University, Oklahoma Department of Mental Health and Substance Abuse Prevention Services and Substance Abuse Mental Health Services Administration.
Well, a new pitcher on for Arkansas Monticello, the 6-foot senior out of Roxy, Mississippi. Will be number 16, Jacob McDaniel. And coming in for relief for Connor Irvin as the first batter he'll face is Hagan Barcelo. Barcelo with a towering fly ball into left as Wolf will camp underneath it right in front of the track, make the grab for out number one, and there's one down as retreating back to first is Chad Green. Numbers on McDaniel, a 4.35 earned run average. He is 2-1, his 17th appearance. He's gone 20 2/3, 17 hits, 13 runs, 10 of those earned. 8 walks to 15 strikeouts. Teams are hitting just .221 against Jacob McDaniel this season as Trevor Sayre will bat. 1-for-2 today, struck out in the second, singled and scored a run in the third. As Sayre fouls that one, it'll go back to the net. Count will be 0-1 to Trevor Sayre. And runner on first is Chad Green after he led off the inning with a walk. Here's the 0-1 pitch. That's outside from McDaniel. Count evens up 1-1. Green with his lead from first. McDaniel checks the runner. Now ready to go with a 1-1. Sharply hit ball to short. There's 6-4, 3 to turn it. Sayre beats it out at first. Nicely done there. Good speed from Trevor Sayre.
Yeah, he's hard to double up. And he's coming out of the right, left-hand side of the box, too.
So fielder's choice for Trevor Sayre. As the third baseman, Colby Grace, will bat. Well, he hit a big two-run home run to right center last time up.
Yeah. I'm not sure we won't see Sayre going.
He's got 5 stolen bases in 7 attempts. That's a fly ball down the right field line. That could be trouble, and that will land just foul. As the count will be 0-1.
Their right fielder closed on it pretty quick. I didn't think he was going to get there. And if that ball would have stayed fair, he may have been able to have caught that.
So the count will be 0-1 to Colby Grace.
But I like seeing him going to right field on those outside pitches.
Especially when you do it the first time, kind of starts to get in your mind as a outfielder as well that this guy can do this.
Yeah.
Here's the 0-1 to Grace. It's upstairs from McDaniel. Count evens up 1-1.
Yeah, as a plate umpire now, you've got a pitcher that's dropping down. His release point's much lower, and so you're having to reestablish the zone a little bit. That looked like a pretty good pitch.
Here's the 1-1. Popped up just into the grass in shallow center. Making the grab will be Cripps, the second baseman, and that'll do it for the Rangers here in the fifth as they pick up. No runs on, no hits, no errors with one left on. We move to the sixth. Northwestern leading it 7-4 on the Community Bank scoreboard. This is Northwestern Baseball brought to you by Holder Drug and the Rangers Sports Network.
When was the last time you evaluated your investment goals? With our ever-changing environment, it's time. Talk to us about locking in a high, long-term fixed interest rate and put your money to work for you. I'm Whitney Gum, and here at E&J Financial, we work with you to implement a custom plan to fit your financial goals. Call our office today at 580-327-2552 to book a complimentary financial review.
Securities offered through registered representatives of Cambridge Investment Research, member FINRA, SIPC. Advisory services offered through Cambridge Investment Research Advisors. Cambridge and E&J Financial are not affiliated.
K&S Tire in Alva has been locally owned and operated since 2004. While every business claims to be the best, K&S Tire is the best. Our satisfied customers speak for themselves by coming back to us each and every time. Our amazing services goes beyond a regular tune-up or tire rotation. Our team is well-trained and able to take care of all your car care needs, including preventative maintenance, wheel alignments, brakes, and more. Visit knstire.com for more information or come see us at 2590 College Boulevard right here in Alva.
The Tacoma Farmers Co-op is a proud supporter of Ranger and Gold Bug activities since 1916. They have been here to serve you with all your farming and ranching needs with a wide range of goods and services from fuel, hardware, fencing, tires, feed and seed, plus fertilizer. They're here to meet your needs. Choose to trade with a co-op that gives its profits back to you. To learn about the Tacoma Co-op Advantage, stop by one of five locations in Moreland, Freedom, Winoka, Jet, and Tacoma, or visit them at tacomacoop.com and get a better service at a better place.
Catcher number two, Chaz Poppy, will lead things off as he takes ball one from DeHaas. They get 2-0 now. That pitch misses low. Chaz Poppy followed by Chase Cripps and Kirk Wolf. Due up for the Weevils as we move to the top of the sixth inning. Rangers leading at 7-4. Here's the 2-0. That's in there for a called strike. Count goes to 2-1.
Good pitch. Fastball outside corner. Come back with another one.
2-1. That's hit into right center, and that may be trouble. Sarah on the run, laid out. It goes off of his glove. Here's the throw back in, and it's a leadoff double for Chaz Poppy. Boy, Sarah made a great attempt at it, just couldn't come up with it.
Yeah, it's excellent effort. I mean, it hit in his glove, and just as he was hitting the ground, his body and just jarred it out.
So Trevor Stiles will go out and have a word with Garrett DeHaas, and Chase Cripps will now step into the batter's box. He's 0-1 today. Rangers do have action in the bullpen. I believe that's Dawson Toborg up for Northwestern. Home plate umpire going out now.
I think there's a bit more before we can consider having him chased off the mound. I mean, he's, again, we got 3-run lead, top of six. He's been on top of most of the hitters today. You know, after he got past that first inning.
Now batting second baseman, Chase Cripps.
Now Coach Bowen is going to come out, and we are going to see a pitching change here in this top of the sixth inning. This called the bullpen, brought to you by Ignite Physical Therapy, as Coach Bowen comes out for a G&G Home Furnishings mound visit. So we'll see a new pitcher for the Rangers come back after this. This is Northwestern Baseball, brought to you by Holder Drug on the Ranger Sports Network.
Naloxone is a medication designed to rapidly reverse opioid overdose. A person who is experiencing an overdose can't administer naloxone to themselves. Anyone can carry naloxone, give it to someone experiencing an overdose, and potentially save a life. That's why everyone should consider having naloxone. For more information, visit okimready.org. That's okimready.org. This program is funded by Northwestern Oklahoma State University, Oklahoma Department of Mental Health and Substance Abuse Prevention Services, and Substance Abuse Mental Health Services Administration.
818 Diner has consistently provided the city of Alva with quality comfort food and great service since opening in 2019. Join us for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. Some of our popular menu items to choose from include the BCB Burger, the French Dip, and our staples such as Terry's Chicken Fried Steak, Don's Hamburger Steak, and Joe's Chicken Tenders. Open Monday and Wednesday through Sunday from 6 a.m. to 2 p.m. and open for dinner Wednesday through Friday, 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. So if you want a variety of menu items and friendly service to give you that local diner feeling, visit 818 Diner right here in Alva.
Dingall Real Estate and Auction has been serving clients in Oklahoma and Kansas for nearly 37 years. If you're looking to buy, sell, or invest, we are your real estate professionals. We will get you the top dollar for your property, whether it be at auction or private sale. Get with Dingall Real Estate and Auction if you're wanting to buy a ranch, good farmland, sell or lease minerals, or buy a home. Visit our website at dingallauction.com to browse available listings. Talk to Dean, Steve, or Todd at 580-327-8217 or stop by the office in Alva, where you're always greeted with a smile. Come and see us.
Spring is here, and so are the savings at G&G Home Furnishings in Alva. Right now, it's our annual anniversary sale happening through the month of April. Mattresses starting at $299, Lazy Boy recliners at $499, sofas at $399, dining room sets at $599, and bedroom sets starting at just $329. Don't miss out on all the savings throughout the month of April, so stop in and browse during our anniversary sale happening at G&G Home Furnishings, located at 2107 College Boulevard, right here in Alva.
New pitcher for the Rangers out of the pen will be number 16, the right-handed, 6'2" right-handed junior, number 16, Dawson Toborg. Coming in for relief, again for Garrett DeHaas. Toborg this season, a 2.89 earned run average. He's 2-2, 16th appearance, does have one save. 28 innings, 24 hits, 11 runs, 9 earned, 10 walks, 21 strikeouts. Teams are hitting 233 against him so far this season. First pitch is a ground ball hit to Barcelo. Here's the throw to first in time. The Mooner Poppy does move to third on the 4-3 put out of Cripps.
Yep, that's what the hitter needed to do minimally, and he did.
So now Kirk Wolf, the left fielder, will step in. He's 1-for-2 today, struck out in the first, and then doubled and scored a run in the fourth.
If you get a hard grounder, you want to look that runner back and go one.
Here's the pitch. Upstairs from Toborg to Wolf. Count is 1-0 now.
That's infield and outfield straight away.
Here's the 1-0. That one goes off the glove of Stiles. Runner from third is going to try, and he will slide in safely and touch home plate, and it's now 7-5. Count also moves to 2-0 now to Kirk Wolf, and well, the Weevils creep a little bit closer now as it's 7-5 here in the sixth.
Yeah, I'd be surprised if somebody doesn't, before this game's over, get into the double digits. So there's more runs to be had, but that was unfortunate. Pass ball looked like to me.
Here's the 2-0 in there for a called strike. Count moves to 2-1. It was officially scored a pass ball. Here's the 2-1. Grounder hit down the third base side, gets by Grace. That went into left. Heading for second is Kirk Wolf, and he slides in safely. So a runner at second in scoring position with one out is Kirk Wolf.
Just inside the bag, fairly sharply hit, and tried to short hop it and had too much bounce on it.
So Kirk Wolf will have his second double of the game. And the tying run now comes to the plate by way of Aiden Garrett, who's 1-for-2 today. Garrett struck out looking in the second but had the two-run home run in the fourth. Here's the delivery. Garrett again, a long fly ball into right. This one going back, and I think he's just tied the game, and he did. Another two-run home run by Aiden Garrett has tied it up at 7. So coming in to score from second is Wolf on the two-run shot is Aiden Garrett. Has had a heck of a day at the plate. Give him 6 home runs on the season now. Now 22 RBIs.
Was that second pitch, first pitch he hit?
First pitch,
yeah.
So Brody Romero will step in. He's 0-for-2 today. There's a high chopper on the ground to short as Wiltshire fields off the hop, throws to first in time for the 6-3 put out, and there's two down.
Yeah, speaking with his dad, you know, you can just picture, you know, the 8-year-old Wiltshire firing it over to the 8-year-old Bradford.
Yeah. That's exactly right. Well, now the DH, Logan Jones, will step in. He's 0-for-2 today. Flew out to left twice in the second and again in the fourth. Toborg, that one's hit into center. Back goes Sayre in front of the track, makes the grab, and that'll do it for the Weevils here in the sixth. However, they do pick up 3 more runs to tie it up on 3 hits, no errors, with nobody left on. We move to the bottom of the sixth inning. Score tied at 7 on the Community Bank scoreboard. This is Northwestern Baseball, brought to you by Holder Drug on the Ranger Sports Network.
Looking for the best in lawn care? Peak Environment has you covered. We offer a wide range of services, including full-service mowing, weed control, Christmas light installation, and more. Peak Environment provides efficient and affordable services across Northwest Oklahoma with branches in Alva, Enid, and Woodward. Call our office today at 580-748-8003 for a free quote on any service. That's Peak Environment, 748-8003. Proud supporter of all Ranger and Gold Bug Athletics.
The Alva Moose Lodge is a proud supporter of all Northwestern and Alva public school activities and strives to be the heart of the community through fundraisers and community-based events that make a difference in the lives of individuals, kids, and families throughout Northwest Oklahoma. On a national basis, the Moose Fraternity provides at-risk children with a second chance at life and its senior members a comforting retirement at its five-star senior facility in Florida. If you would like to see how you can help make a difference in the lives of those in need, stop by the Alva Moose Lodge Monday through Saturday from 4 p.m. to 10:30 p.m. at 302 7th Street to learn more.
Keeping your car clean is an inexpensive way to protect its value. Shirley Shine Car Wash, located west of Love, offers a six-bay self-serve car wash, including three truck bays. Your wash options include soap, tire cleaner, foamy brush, wax, spot-free rinse, and air chamois. And you can pay with credit, debit card, or quarters. Don't just clean the outside. Clean the inside with its self-serve car vacuum. You can also clean your pet with their self-serve dog wash. Company vehicle? Be sure to ask about our fleet account. So the next time your vehicle needs rinsed or detailed, come by Shirley Shine Car Wash, located right here in Alva.
Welcome back to Meyer Stadium as we head to the top of the or bottom of the sixth inning. As Trevor Stiles, the catcher, will lead it off as the first pitch is outside for ball one. Stiles 0 for 2 today, struck out twice. Struck out in the third and the third again when the Rangers batted around in the third inning. Here's the 1-0. That's a line shot into left and on the run, making the grab, laying out for it was Wolf to take a base hit away from Stiles, and there's one down. Oh, and I thought for a second that ball was going to pop out of the glove of Wolf, and it did not, but
yeah,
so he took a hit there.
Yeah, he was able to keep it folded up.
So now to the plate, the shortstop, number nine, Jacob Wiltshire. Rangers looking to get something going here. As again, we're tied at seven on the Community Bank scoreboard. Rangers got all seven runs in the third. Weevils have spread it out here today with their seven runs. Two in the first, two in the fourth, three in the sixth. As the first pitch to Wiltshire misses for ball one. 1-0 count, again, one out here in the bottom of the sixth inning. And it's game one of our doubleheader. Here's the 1-0. That outside for ball two. Tell you what, that crowd mic picks up about everything, doesn't it? Get that kid a snow cone. Two balls, no strikes to Wiltshire.
If some of our ornery friends knew we were here, imagine what would be said in passing.
2-0 pitch is in there for a called strike as the count goes to 2-1 now.
You know, had Terry Ross spotted that?
Oh, yeah. We're in trouble. He'd probably have a little message for us, right? There's the 2-1 pitch. That's lifted into right center. On the run is Hawthorne. He'll make the grab for out number two. Hawthorne with good speed, able to get to that one.
Yep, well, he had to cover a lot of area. I thought it was going to go further out.
So, really, you can look at it. The first two hitters have kind of had a base hit taken away from them.
Yep.
By two good defensive plays. As we go back to the top of the order with the first baseman, number seven, Dylan Bradford.
They stayed inside on him last at bat.
Bradford 1-for-3 today. He'll take a called strike from McDaniel. Count is 0-1.
Every inning, need base runners. Got a good hitter on deck. Bradford's speed, he can score from first.
There's the 0-1. That's in there again. Count goes to 0-2 now to Dylan Bradford.
Yeah, see on the overhand pitchers, those were kind of high. Drop down pitcher here, that was called a strike. That was almost to the letters.
There is action in the Weevils bullpen, a right-hander up. The 0-2 from McDaniel, and Bradford goes around, and it's called strike three, and the Rangers go in order here in the sixth inning. No runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left on. Top of the seventh we go. Score tied at seven. This is Northwestern Baseball, brought to you by Holder Drug on the Rangers Sports Network.
At Ignite Physical Therapy, we assist in the therapy of many different aspects, such as advanced problem solving, joint mobilization, treatment of adverse neural tension, evaluation and treatment of muscle imbalance, tissue-specific exercise, and patient education. Dr. Jared Hayda and staff want to get you back to the life that you had before your injury. They have helped so many through rehabilitation, and they can do the same for you. Stop by and see the staff at Ignite Physical Therapy on 520 Flynn Street or make an appointment by calling 580-327-3331.
We know how much love your pet gives you. We're Ridgeview Veterinary Hospital. We're always here for you and your pet. Ridgeview Vet Hospital provides the most comprehensive care from regular checkups to emergency. Ridgeview Vet Hospital proudly provides veterinary services to all animals, large or small. Visit us today to let Dr. Lohman and his staff take care of your extended family located right here in Alva, or call us to schedule your appointment at 580-327-0201. Ridgeview Vet Hospital is a proud supporter of Alva and Northwestern activities.
Your agency of choice for all types of insurance is McDermott Insurance in Alva. For home, auto, farm, or business insurance, the McDermott Agency will protect what you value most by providing the best coverage and client service possible. To get your custom professional insurance review, call McDermott Insurance at 580-327-3500 or visit them at 526 Flynn Street in Alva. McDermott Insurance. They can't predict the future, but they can insure it.
Center fielder number one, Rock Hawthorne, will lead it off for the Weevils as we open up play in the seventh. Is that opening pitch brought to you by Ridgeview Vet Hospital is in there for a called strike. Count is 0-1. Hawthorne followed by Camden Tanner and Cade Kinsia. And the 0-1. And there again for a called strike. Count is 0-2 now. Hawthorne 1-for-3 today. Singled in the third, grounded out to second in the first, struck out in his last at bat in the fifth. Here's the 0-2. That's a high chopper hit, foul to the right side. Count will stay at 0-2 now to Rock Hawthorne. And Rangers with 7 runs on 8 hits. Weevils 7 runs on 7 hits. Both teams have combined to leave 5 runners on base. 3 for Northwestern, 2 for the Weevils. 0-2 pitch into the turf, low for ball one. Count will go to 1-2. One ball, 2 strikes to Hawthorne. Toborg resets, ready to go from the rubber.
Shortstop is shaded heavily to second base bag.
1-2. Upstairs for ball two. Count evens up 2-2 now. Keep in mind, game two of the doubleheader scheduled to start at 6 p.m. here this evening. We're about 35 minutes past 4 o'clock. We're on a beautiful Friday in Alva, Oklahoma. 2-2 pitch, swung on and missed for strike three as Hawthorne has struck out now in his last 2 at-bats. As again, there's one down here in the seventh.
Speaking of that, where were you during the eclipse?
I was in the recruitment office. I did get a small look at it.
Well, I know Jody and Annie and Jay and Tracy went down to Hoochatown, you know, the totality down there in the broken boat.
Oh, yeah. There's a line shot past the first baseman, Bradford. That's going to get into the corner and right. Rounding first, heading for second is Camden Tanner. He's going to have a one-out stand-up double. And a runner in scoring position now for the Weevils.
Not much you could do about that.
Nope. Bradford laid out for it, but that was a hard-hit ball off the bat of Camden Tanner. That's his first hit of the game. Cade Kinsella now will hit. He's 0-for-2 today. He did walk back in the first and scored a run, but he flew out to center in the third, grounded out to second in the fifth.
Well, that time of day the other day, I don't think anybody was playing baseball, but wasn't that big a deal? You got to turn on the lights.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, you go from daylight to nighttime.
Toborg upstairs for ball one. And on deck is Chaz Poppy. Had a pretty good day at the plate today.
Just need to settle in here and get the batter and get one out at a time. Got one down now.
Toborg checks the runner at second. Here's the 1-0, fouled back to the net. Count evens up 1-1.
Yeah, he may have swung at a ball there, too.
Again, these two teams tied with Arkansas Tech at the top of the Great American Conference. Very, very important series this weekend for both clubs. In the ninth in Bethany, Henderson State leading SNU 11-5. Southern Arkansas leading Southwestern in the fourth, 6-2 in Weatherford. Here's the 1-1 from Toborg. Just missed there for ball two. Count moves to 2-1 now.
Yeah, from here, was that in? Was that up? Could you tell what that was?
I guess it must have been a little bit up and in. Not much, though. I thought it was a pretty good pitch from Toborg.
I did, too. I thought it came in on the inside corner, just what you're wanting to jam him. Been staying outside on him.
2-1. That's in there for a called strike. Count evens up 2-2 now. Southern Arkansas has plated another run. They now lead it 7-2 in the fourth in Weatherford. Wachita thumping Oklahoma Baptist 10-0, and that's in the first inning at Shawnee. Oof, tough start for the Fighting Todd Millers.
That's a baseball game?
Yeah. 2-2, that's trouble. Into right center, and that is going to be trouble. That's down for a base hit. Sarah will field throw back in, but that's going to score a run as Arkansas Monticello reclaims the lead after the long single by Kinsia. As Tanner scores from second, it's now 8-7 Weevils.
But that is okay. This is two good teams battling it. Good pitching, good hitting, good defense. We're just going to have to outlast them.
So Chaz Poppy, who's been dangerous today, 2-for-3, two-run home run in the first, hit into a 6-4-3 double play. Let's see if we can recreate that here, and then doubled and scored a run in the sixth. First pitch from Toborg. Ground ball to third, 5-4, now to 3, and he did it again. As Poppy hits into another double play to end the inning here in the seventh. But the Weevils do get one run on two hits, no errors, with nobody left on. As it's now our time for our seventh inning stretch, again brought to you by Peak Environment, as we head to the bottom of the seventh. Rangers trailing at 8-7 on the Community Bank scoreboard. This is Northwestern Baseball, brought to you by Holder Drug on the Ranger Sports Network.
Alva Health and Wellness is Alva's newest healthcare option, offering a broad array of services geared to address today's most common illnesses and injuries. Alva Health and Wellness offers services for you and your child, including sickness, wellness, chronic care management, vaccinations, weight loss, and so much more. Find more information online by visiting alvahealthandwellness.com or come by and make an appointment with Jeremy Logston in person at 515 College Avenue right here in Alva.
Don't miss the Monster Truck Spring Nationals. One giant show this Saturday, 8 p.m. Crystal Beach Stadium, Woodward, Oklahoma. See the baddest trucks on the planet in ground-pounding, car-crushing action, including Animal House, driven by the world's youngest female driver. She's only 15 years old. She'll take on Dysfunctional, Kicking and Screaming, Redneck Rampage, and Sergeant Smash. Don't miss the Oklahoma Tough Truck Contest, where locals run for cash. Special VIP box seats and pit passes, included attendance to the pre-show pit party. Drinks with trucks, autographs, and kids meet Batman, plus a superhero souvenir. You can even take a ride in a real monster truck. Tickets available at United Grocery, Napa, Cowboy Tech Shop, Woodward Steel, at the gate, or online at showclix.com. Sponsored by Advanced Real Estate Advisors and Cool Brothers Collision, Northwestern Electric Co-op, K&S Tire, Red Prairie, SPC, Red Dirt Gun and Pawn, and Great Plains Bank. Monster Truck Spring National this Saturday, Woodward. Be there.
Welcome back to Meyer Stadium as we move to the bottom of the seventh. Again, it was our seventh inning stretch brought to you by Peak Environment as Carson Wright will lead it off. He's 2-for-3 at the plate today as the first pitch from McDaniel is in there for a called strike. Count is 0-1. Carson Wright followed by Paul Sachin and Chad Green due up for the Rangers here in the bottom of the seventh inning. Here's the 0-1. That one's inside. Count evens up. 1-1 to Carson Wright. Struck out in the first, single and scored a run in the third, and doubled in the fourth. So again, the Rangers trailing at 8-7 here in the bottom of the seventh inning. That went just a little bit high for ball two. Count moves to 2-1. Of course, the Rangers do have 6 walk-off wins this year. Haven't had one in a while. A lot of those came on early on in the season, but
yeah.
2-1 pitch. That's outside for ball three. Good eye from right. McDaniel has yet to walk anybody since coming in for relief for Irvin. He does have one strikeout.
If he gives me one I like, I'm turning on it, but otherwise I'm going to be selective here.
3-1 is ball four. Leadoff walk drawn by Carson Wright, and the Rangers have a base runner as the tying run heads to first base.
Now batting for the Rangers, right fielder, Paul Sitchin.
So now Paul Sitchin will hit. As we're going to get a visit to the mound brought to you by G&G Home Furnishings, and I think we are going to see a new pitcher as well for the Weevils. So looks like McDaniel's day will be done as the Weevils go to the bullpen. This call the bullpen brought to you by Ignite Physical Therapy. We'll talk about the new Weevils pitcher next. This is Northwestern Baseball brought to you by Holder Drug on the Ranger Sports Network.
Alva State Bank and Trust Company, older than Oklahoma, big enough to serve you and small enough to know you.
We love to give back to our customers. Did you know Alva State Bank offers a great rewards checking account program? That's right. You can earn cash back or high interest with our Kasasa accounts. We will even refund you up to $25 in ATM fees.
How do I qualify?
It's simple. Just swipe your debit card 12 times, sign up for online statements, and have one ACH credit or debit post to your account.
Can I do it online?
Yes. Just visit our website at www.alvastatebank.com to see if our Kasasa Rewards program is right for you.
We make banking easy. Whether you're at home, the office, or in your car, our online or mobile banking options help you juggle busy schedules and financial needs.
We plant roots where others have branches.
Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
Holder Drug has been serving the community of Alva since 1952. When you are in need of medication, healthcare items, and more, look to none other than Holder Drug, Alva's local pharmacy. Holder Drug is locally and family-owned and is always ready to serve you. They offer convenient drive-through pickup as well as free delivery with your medication. They also offer a number of gift ideas for those special holidays. For more information, visit their website, www.holderdrug.com, or stop by 513 Barnes Avenue in downtown Alva.
Community Bank has been serving Alva, Oklahoma, and the surrounding area since 1984. Community Bank was founded by local community members who wanted to ensure the banking needs of the community were being met. It has been our goal since inception to provide customer-focused services and community development. Our customers are friends, neighbors, and never just a number. We believe in investing in our community, and we pride ourselves in being your hometown bank. Community Bank, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
Well, Weevils will have a new pitcher, the 6-foot junior right-hander out of Temecula, California, transfer out of Grossmont Community College, number 37, Dylan Vail. 5.13 earned run average, he's 2-1, 15th appearance. 26 and a third, 19 hits, 16 runs, 15 of those earned, 15 walks to 28 strikeouts. Teams are hitting just 200 against Vail this season. As Sachin fouls that pitch back to open things up at this at-bat, count will be 0-1.
Came right at him with the fastball upstairs a little bit.
DeHaas goes 5 innings, 81 pitches, 5 hits, 5 runs, 4 earned, 3 walks, 5 strikeouts. Toborg goes 2, 20 pitches, 4 hits, 3 runs, all 3 earned, and a strikeout. The 0-1 line drive goes off the glove of the first baseman, Cancia, and that one's going to wind up in foul territory into right.
Make him throw.
Headed to second and holding up at third for the Rangers is Carson Wright, and Northwestern's in business here in the seventh. So a single from Sachin, that's his first hit of the game. So now Chad Green steps in.
That went right off the end of the first baseman's glove. I'm wondering if he's thinking, gosh, I knew I should have gotten that extra large glove before the season started.
Well, Green has been good today, 2-for-2. That pitch up and in for ball one. Doubled in the second, singled and scored a run in the third, and as he drove in two and walked in the fifth. But a chance, the tying run at third, leading run at second. 1-0 pitch, just inside and off the plate. Count moves to 2-0. That was a good pitch from Dale, though, or Vail.
Yeah, must have been inside. And look for your pitch right here. Otherwise, take it.
Here's the 2-0. Swung on and missed. Count moves to 2-1. And it's the dangerous part of the order for the Rangers. It'll be Green followed by Hagan Barcelo, Trevor Serra, and Colby Grace.
He was hoping that was a fastball, but it was not. Curveball.
Here's the 2-1. And he chased that one on the outside. Count evens up 2-2.
Got to make contact here. Make them make a decision whether they're going to come home with the ball or eat the run.
2-2, that's called strike three. As Chad Green strikes out looking for the first out here in the bottom of the seventh inning.
Now batting for the Rangers, second baseman, Hagan.
So now to the plate, Hagan Barcelo. He's 1-for-3 today with 3 RBIs. Had that big 3-run home run in the third. Also got a pair of flyouts.
That'll
There's a chopper.
Up.
That's going to be fielded by the pitcher, Vail. He'll flip to first, but scoring from third is Carson Wright. And the game is now tied at 8 on the Community Bank scoreboard.
Yeah, it was right off the end of the bat with some nasty spin. He picked it up firmly to get him out at 1.
So both teams with 8 runs and 9 hits each. As Trevor Serra with an opportunity to give the Rangers a lead. The leading run 90 feet away at third is Paul Sachin. As Serra pops this one up, it will get back out over the press box out of play. Count will be 0-1.
Sometimes we just look like we're in too much of a hurry to hit. I mean, make this guy work a little bit. Get the pitch you want. Just because it's a strike doesn't mean you need to go be cutting at it all the time.
The 0-1 from Vail. And that's in there for a strike. And Serra quickly behind in the count, 0-2 now.
Yep.
And a fielder's choice last time up at the fifth. Singled and scored a run in the third. Struck out in the second.
Got a battle here. Battle. You got a buddy at third. You need to bring him home.
And the 0-2. Just that one jammed on the inside, and that one's a grounder hit to Kinsella. He'll step on first, and that'll do it for the Rangers here in the seventh. They do tie this one up as they pick up 1 run on 1 hit, no error, with 1 left on. Top of the eighth we go. Score tied at 8 on the Community Bank scoreboard. Weevils do up when we come back. This is Northwestern Baseball brought to you by Holder Drug on the Rangers Sports Network.
Do you need assistance taking care of yourself or a loved one? Beatles Nursing Home in Alva is here for you. We offer safe, high-quality, affordable nursing care while meeting all care guidelines for living. Call us at 580-327-1274 to learn more about our admissions process to place your loved one in our care. When it's time to choose a nursing home facility, we'll hope you'll consider Beatles Nursing Home located at 916 Noble Street in Alva.
Here at Bank Central, we like to shoot for three, and that includes our services to you. From fee-free checking accounts to competitive CD rates and all the way to consumer lending, stop by any of our locations in Alva, Enid, Woodward, and Cherokee, or call 580-327-1122 to talk with one of our qualified professionals. Bank Central, where we're centered on you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Certain fees and restrictions may apply.
You put in the work, and every day you go out and prove it again. You're an expert in your field. That's what farmers do every day. They go out and get the job done. If that's you, then Farm Credit of Western Oklahoma wants to thank you. For a livestock or crop loan, equipment loan, ag real estate, or operating loan, we will tailor a loan to your needs. Talk to one of our ag specialists by phone or stop by a branch today. Farm Credit of Western Oklahoma, an equal housing opportunity lender, online at farmcreditloans.com.
Welcome back here to Glass Family Field at Meyer Stadium as second baseman number 9, Chase Cripps, will lead it off as we open up play here in the top of the eighth. Rangers and the Weevils tied at 8 on the Community Bank scoreboard. Here is also joined by Ranger, former Ranger baseball player and Hall of Famer, Mike Perkins. Mike, how are you, sir?
I'm doing great, Dustin. Thanks for having me in. Perfect day for ball out here in the great panhandle.
Yeah, that's perfect. Right. You've got to see plenty of games so far this season, haven't you, on the road?
Seen a few, yes. Followed you guys on the computer, so it's all good.
The 0-1 pitch up coming to Cripps. Toborg delivers, and he only going to say he was hit by the pitch. Well, thoughts on today? Look good so far, you think?
It's been a pretty even game. It's going to be some give and take, and We knew there'd be some balls hit out of the yard. Everybody's delivered on that so far.
What it's wild to me is, you know, all the wind we had last week, it was blowing a lot harder, and then not nearly as much today as you see the flag, but boy, the balls are just jumping out of here today.
The air is light, that's for sure.
Kirk Wolf will step into the batter's box now as that pitch just missed for ball one. Wolf 2-for-3 today, also struck out once. And Chase Cripps, the runner on first after he was hit by the pitch. Here's the 1-0. That's swung on and missed. Count evens up 1-1. Well, you came for the right series, and this is a big one this weekend with opportunity to maybe still be tied for first after this thing, or, you know, maybe in sole possession.
I was excited to get this series in. Looking back the last week or so, watching it develop, this was good. Perfect timing for me.
Here's the 1-1. In there again for a called strike as the count moves to 1-2 now.
Monticello's been heating up the last couple of weeks. Been watching them. They're coming up through the ranks.
No, they have. They've definitely picked it up in conference plays. Struggled in non-conference, but we get into conference play where it matters. They've been very, very good. Here's the 1-2. That's outside. Count evens up 2-2 now. How good, I'm sure you've probably seen this, but Northwestern being at home, you remember being this good at home at 19-4. I mean, probably not since I've been here. It's probably been a while.
No, that's an amazing record at home, as it should be. I never played on a team that good, but we won more than we lost up here just because you knew the environment. But everybody ought to be good at home.
Two balls, two strikes to the hitter, Kirk Wolf. Again, the runner on first, Chase Cripps. Nobody out, top of the eighth, score tied at 8. This one's popped up. I believe it's going to get out of play again to the right. So we'll stay at 2-2. Well, they started making food over there just yet.
Looked like they were heating it up.
Yeah.
Yeah, there was a bunch of people busy over there.
And I think once we get past 5 o'clock, I think we get into that second game, I think the crowd's going to really start to be here for the game tonight.
Right. Both teams, the starting pitchers did their job, got about halfway through the game because it's going to be a tough series on pitching.
2-2 pitch just missed off the corner. Count goes to 3-2 now. Have you had a chance to make any other home games? I think we've been a couple times, right?
Last year, but I just saw him over in Enid the other night.
Yeah.
I'll catch this one this weekend, and I'll follow him over to Tahlequah Tuesday.
3-2 pitch. Oh, they're going to say it was inside again. Mm. Two tough pitches in a row. And now Coach Bowen having a word with the home plate umpire. And again, it's kind of been like that today with some of the calls behind home plate.
Yeah.
Hear the fans getting into it. They're a little not happy. Well, home plate umpire is going to go. I think we just got a warning. So Weevils with runners at first and second now. Nobody out as Aiden Garrett, the shortstop, stepping in. And now home plate umpire still having a word with Coach Bowen from the dugout. I think he's to the point where he goes, that's it, no more. Of course, I love the crowd. Mike picks up a lot of everything.
It's going to spice it up here these last two or three innings.
Well, we're going to see Coach Bowen come out for a mound visit. Again, it's brought to you by G&G Home Furnishings. Let's take a 30-second break and come back. This is Northwestern Baseball brought to you by Holder Drug on the Ranger Sports Network.
Get no better deal in the country than at Croft Country, located in Alva, Oklahoma. Croft Country is the dealer for vehicles in Northwest Oklahoma. Croft Country is locally owned and operated since 1985, offering a full line of award-winning brands including Chevy and GMC. From the time you enter our showroom for sales or service, you can expect to be treated like family. So the next time you're in the market for a new or used vehicle, come see us right here in Alva, located at 401 East Oklahoma Boulevard.
Anger, anxiety, worry, and disbelief. These are normal emotions to feel with an unplanned pregnancy. You have options, and you are not alone. Hope Pregnancy Center in Alva is a safe, confidential, and compassionate place to land. Hope offers free pregnancy testing and ultrasound, and you will be provided education for all your options. Remember, you aren't alone. We can help with hope. Visit thinkimpregnant.org. That's thinkimpregnant.org.
Shortstop Aiden Garrett back into the box with nobody out as he'll show bunt. Well, that bunt attempt is bunted foul. Count will be 0-1. Runners, though, at first and second for the Weevils. And I think this is a big spot for the Rangers here defensively. You want to get out of this without giving up any runs any way you can.
It looks like he's going to try to move at least one runner over. It'd be nice if we could keep the double play intact behind him because we've got, what, two already today?
Two already today, yeah. The 0-1, and again, bunted foul. This one straight back to the net, and Garrett quickly behind in the count, 0-2. And Garrett, again, keep in mind, has been the guy who's hit two big bombs today for the Weevils. He's got four RBIs today on those two-run home runs. It is an 0-2 count to Aiden Garrett. And the delivery. It's outside for ball one. The count moves to 1-2. Cripps at second, Wolf at first. Checks the runner, now comes home. Cole, strike three.
Oh boy.
He rung him up there. Garrett strikes out looking.
Good pitch.
We might have gotten that call, too, you know, just now after everything that's happened, you know. You get those advantages at home sometimes.
Now the umpire's getting it from the other bench, so it's all evened out. We're all good.
So now to the plate, Brody Romero. Runners at first and second with one out. Toborg checks the runner, now comes home. Tried the outside corner and missed. Count moves to 1-0. My Mike, games like these, you know, so important, especially when you're tied for top of the league and you want to stay there and got a chance to maybe host a home playoff game later in the season.
Every pitch matters right now. Throw us a two ball, get out of it, that'd be great.
That pitch was inside. Romero checked his swing. They appealed down to first. They say he did not go around as the count moves to 2-0 now. Toborg checks the runner at second. Now comes home with a 2-1. That one fouled off to the left towards the Northwestern dugout. Count moved to 2-1. You know, Coach Barrows and I talked about this, how many walk-off wins we've had this season, and which is just, you know, you'd think one or two maybe here. I think we've had six so far this year.
And that, you know, got them early, and it set the tone for the season. They were mature at bats late in the game by some really good hitters. And, boy, that goes a long way with confidence.
Goes to 3-1 as that pitch missed outside. And three balls, one strike to Romero. Here's the pitch, and it's, well, they're going to say it hit him apparently for ball four. And the bases are now going to be loaded as Cripps to third, Wolf to second, and Romero at first. Seems like they're going to leave Toborg out there to face Logan Jones. He's 0 for 3 today. And there's only one out. He's flown out three times, though. Here's the pitch to Jones. That's a line drive down the right field line. And that will at least score one. It will score two as two runs come in to score. And it's now 10-8 Arkansas Monticello as Romero moves all the way to third. So first hit of the day by Logan Jones. So I think we are going to see a pitching change now as Coach Bowen will come out for another mound visit. We will talk about the new pitcher when we come back after this break. This is Northwestern Baseball brought to you by Holder Drug on the Ranger Sports Network.
To prevent medication from getting into the wrong hands, it is crucial to store it out of sight and out of the reach of children and visitors. In addition, it is important to dispose of unwanted, expired, and unused medications in a safe manner. For more information, visit okimready.org. That's okimready.org or call 988 Oklahoma's Mental Health Lifeline. This program is funded by Northwestern Oklahoma State University, Oklahoma Department of Mental Health and Substance Abuse Prevention Services and Substance Abuse Mental Health Services Administration.
When was the last time you evaluated your investment goals? With our ever-changing environment, it's time. Talk to us about locking in a high, long-term fixed interest rate and put your money to work for you. I'm Whitney Gum, and here at E&J Financial, we work with you to implement a custom plan to fit your financial goals. Call our office today at 580-327-2552 to book a complimentary financial review.
Securities offered through registered representatives of Cambridge Investment Research, member FINRA, SIPC. Advisory services offered through Cambridge Investment Research Advisors. Cambridge and E&J Financial are not affiliated.
K&S Tire in Alva has been locally owned and operated since 2004. While every business claims to be the best, K&S Tire is the best. Our satisfied customers speak for themselves by coming back to us each and every time. Our amazing services goes beyond a regular tune-up or tire rotation. Our team is well-trained and able to take care of all your car care needs, including preventative maintenance, wheel alignments, brakes, and more. Visit knstire.com for more information or come see us at 2590 College Boulevard right here in Alva.
Welcome back to Meyer Stadium as we're still here again in the top of the eighth inning. It's 10-8 Arkansas Monticello as the Rangers go to the bullpen. This call the bullpen brought to you by Ignite Physical Therapy. The 6'4" left-handed junior, number 47, Kyle Gashida will come out and pitch for the Rangers as he will come in relief for Dawson Toborg. And we'll see if the Rangers can get out of this jam. There will be runners again at the corners. Mike, this would be a perfect ground ball situation for a double play.
Boy, we need something right now. Just throw strikes.
Gashida with an ERA of 6. He's 1-1. His 10th appearance of the year. 6 innings, 7 hits, 5 runs, 4 of those earned. 5 walks and 5 strikeouts. Teams are hitting .304 against the lefty Kyle Gashida this season. Yeah, I did get to ask you, how's everybody doing? Family's good. You guys recently moved to from out west back to the east. And
from the left coast to Georgia, thankfully. It's beautiful down there. It's quiet. Everybody's nice, patient, unbelievable. We're really happy, really happy. And it's a lot closer to get back here.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's probably a short plane ride going to Atlanta, Planet City, right?
Or a long,
do you guys drive
or a long Jeep ride, yeah. It's all good.
So Rock Hawthorne, the lefty versus lefty matchup here. Hawthorne 1-for-4 today. He has struck out twice. His single came back in the third as Gashida delivers low and way off the plate for ball one. Nice stop from Stiles. Rody Romero at third. Logan Jones at first. Again, there's one out here in the eighth. Weevils leading at 10-8. 1-0 from Gashida is a line drive back up the middle for a base hit. That'll score a run. So scoring from third is Romero. Third run scored by the Weevils this inning on the RBI single from Hawthorne.
Rather see that than walk.
That's true, yeah.
Make them put it in play.
So Camden Tanner. That is his first hit of the game and his last at bat in the seventh. He doubled and scored a run. He's 1-for-3 today. He's also walked once. But runners at first and second now. Gashida delivers. That's a called strike. Count is 0-1. And Logan Jones at second. Hawthorne at first after that RBI single. Weevils now with 11 runs on 11 hits. Gashida checks the runner. Now comes home. That's a fly ball lifted into center. Sayre will camp underneath it. It will tag the runner. Sayre's going to make the long throw to third. Is it going to be in time? No, it goes off the glove of Grace. Backing him up is Gescheidel and allows Hawthorne to take to second now. So runners at second and third, but there are two down. So Kate Cancia will now bat. He's one for three today with an RBI. He's also walked once. If you're the Rangers, well, you'd like to get out of this just down three and still with six outs remaining.
Looks like we're going to have another change.
I think you are right, sir, as Coach Bowen is going to come out for a mound visit brought to you by G&G Home Furnishings. We'll have another pitcher out of the bullpen for Northwestern. We'll talk about him next. Here in the top of the eighth, Rangers tread 11-8. This is Northwestern Baseball brought to you by Holder Drug on the Rangers Sports Network.
Naloxone is a medication designed to rapidly reverse opioid overdose. A person who is experiencing an overdose can't administer naloxone to themselves. Anyone can carry naloxone, give it to someone experiencing an overdose, and potentially save a life. That's why everyone should consider having naloxone. For more information, visit okimready.org. That's okimready.org. This program is funded by Northwestern Oklahoma State University, Oklahoma Department of Mental Health and Substance Abuse Prevention Services and Substance Abuse Mental Health Services Administration.
818 Diner has consistently provided the city of Alva with quality comfort food and great service since opening in 2019. Join us for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. Some of our popular menu items to choose from include the BCB Burger, the French Dip, and our staples such as Terry's Chicken Fried Steak, Don's Hamburger Steak, and Joe's Chicken Tenders. Open Monday and Wednesday through Sunday from 6 a.m. to 2 p.m. and open for dinner Wednesday through Friday, 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. So if you want a variety of menu items and friendly service to give you that local diner feeling, visit 818 Diner right here in Alva.
Dean Gall Real Estate and Auction has been serving clients in Oklahoma and Kansas for nearly 37 years. If you're looking to buy, sell, or invest, we are your real estate professionals. We will get you the top dollar for your property, whether it be at auction or private sale. Get with Dean Gall Real Estate and Auction if you're wanting to buy a ranch, good farmland, sell or lease minerals, or buy a home. Visit our website at deangallauction.com to browse available listing. Talk to Dean, Steve, or Todd at 580-327-8217 or stop by the office in Alva, where you're always greeted with a smile. Come and see us.
Spring is here and so are the savings at G&G Home Furnishings in Alva. Right now it's our annual anniversary sale happening through the month of April. Mattresses starting at $299, Lazy Boy recliners at $499, sofas at $399, dining room sets at $599, and bedroom sets starting at just $329. Don't miss out on all the savings throughout the month of April, so stop in and browse during our anniversary sale happening at G&G Home Furnishings, located at 2107 College Boulevard, right here in Alva.
Well, new pitcher on for the Rangers will be the 5'11 right-handed junior, number four, Jacob Shaw. Shaw coming in a big spot at 2.08 earned run average. He's 5-1, 17th appearance. He does have six saves, 21 2/3, 16 hits, 6 runs, 5 earned, 11 walks, 19 strikeouts. Teams are hitting just .211 against Shaw this season. As he will face Kate Cancia with two down here in the top of the eighth, runners at second and third. And well, if you're Jacob Shaw, Rangers have got to get out of this one right here.
We need a good pitch and a ball hit right at us.
And see again, 1-for-3 today as the first pitch from Shaw is in there for a called strike. Count 0-1. Here's the 0-1. Well, just a touch high, apparently. Count evens up 1-1. That was a good pitch from Shaw. Logan Jones at third, Hawthorne at second. The hitter is Cade Cancia. Here's the 1-1. Ground ball hit foul down the third base side. Count moves to 1-2 now. Probably makes it warmer in here. You can stay in here, Matt. More bodies in here. That 1-2 pitch misses into the turf. County was up 2-2. Nice stop from Stiles.
Just don't get too cute. Yeah. Just challenging. Keep coming. Keep coming at the strike zone.
You know, Shaw trying to get out of this without giving up any more here. Weevils have plated three in the eighth. That's a shot and a line drive at a left center down for a hit. That's going to bounce off the wall. Both runs were score. As clearing the bases with a two RBI double as can see, and it's now 13-8, Arkansas Monticello. So Jones scores from third, from second is Hawthorne, and it's now 13-8. As Chaz Poppy will now bat. Poppy 2-for-4 today. At this point, you just want to get out of here, Mike. Not out of here, but out of the inning anyway.
Get out of the inning somehow. This guy's been trouble all day.
Yeah, he certainly has. Poppy's had a big day at the plate as he fouls that one back. He's had the two big hits with the home run and the double, and then, of course, Poppy's the guy that's hit into two double plays today.
Right.
Rangers have now turned 32 on the season, but trying to stay within striking distance here. Here's the 0-1. Up and in for ball one. Brushed him back a little bit. Count evens up. Shaw checks the runner at second. Here's the 1-1. Oh, that is crushed into left center, and I think that is gone. And it is, as Chaz Poppy with his second two-run home run of the game has given the Weevils a now 15-8 lead.
That was another no-doubter, probably over the road out there.
Boy, and there have been several like that here today. From both teams.
They've not missed them.
Well, so we'll go with Kirk Wolf as the Weevils now batted around here in the top of the eighth. They've scored seven runs as Coach Bowen is going to come out once more. I think we're maybe seeing a pitching change again, and we will. This call to bullpen brought to you by Ignite Physical Therapy. Two down here in the top of the eighth. Rangers trailing at 15-8. This is Northwestern Baseball brought to you by Holder Drug on the Ranger Sports Network.
Looking for the best in lawn care? Peak Environment has you covered. We offer a wide range of services, including full-service mowing, weed control, Christmas light installation, and more. Peak Environment provides efficient and affordable services across Northwest Oklahoma with branches in Alva, Enid, and Woodward. Call our office today at 580-748-8003 for a free quote on any service. That's Peak Environment, 748-8003. Proud supporter of all Ranger and Gold Bug Athletics.
The Alva Moose Lodge is a proud supporter of all Northwestern and Alva public school activities and strives to be the heart of the community through fundraisers and community-based events that make a difference in the lives of individuals, kids, and families throughout Northwest Oklahoma. On a national basis, the Moose Fraternity provides at-risk children with a second chance at life and its senior members a comforting retirement at its five-star senior facility in Florida. If you would like to see how you can help make a difference in the lives of those in need, stop by the Alva Moose Lodge Monday through Saturday from 4 p.m. to 10:30 p.m. at 302 7th Street to learn more.
Keeping your car clean is an inexpensive way to protect its value. Shirley Shine Car Wash, located west of Love, offers a six-bay self-serve car wash, including three truck bays. Your wash options include soap, tire cleaner, foamy brush, wax, spot-free rinse, and air chamois. And you can pay with credit, debit card, or quarters. Don't just clean the outside. Clean the inside with its self-serve car vacuum. You can also clean your pet with their self-serve dog wash. Company vehicle? Be sure to ask about our fleet account. So the next time your vehicle needs rinse or detailed, come by Shirley Shine Car Wash, located right here in Alva.
Welcome back to Myers Stadium. Dustin Goodall alongside Mike Perkins here in the top of the eighth inning. It's 15-8 Arkansas Monticello. A call to bullpen brought to you by Ignite Physical Therapy. Rangers, this will be the third pitcher used here in the eighth, as it'll be the 6'3" left-handed senior out of Wellington, Kansas, number 23, Cade Phelps. Phelps's numbers this season, so we run through those, a 5.4 earned run average. He's 1-1, 14th appearance, 15 innings, 19 hits, 12 runs, 9 of those earned, 9 walks, 18 strikeouts. Teams are hitting .297 against Phelps this season. As Phelps will pitch to Chase Cripps, his second at bat here in the eighth. Last time up, he was hit by a pitch and scored a run. Here's the delivery. Fly ball lifted down the right field line, and it will be caught by Bradford, and that'll do it.
Get out of this.
As the Rangers get out of it here in the eighth, but Weevils do pick up 7 runs on 3 hits. No errors with nobody left on. Bottom of the 8th we go. Rangers trailing at 15-8 on the Community Bank scoreboard. This is Northwestern Baseball brought to you by Holder Drug on the Ranger Sports Network.
We know how much love your pet gives you. We're Ridgeview Veterinary Hospital. We're always here for you and your pet. Ridgeview Vet Hospital provides the most comprehensive care from regular checkups to emergency. Ridgeview Vet Hospital proudly provides veterinary services to all animals, large or small. Visit us today to let Dr. Lohman and his staff take care of your extended family located right here in Alva, or call us to schedule your appointment at 580-327-0201. Ridgeview Vet Hospital is a proud supporter of Alva and Northwestern activities.
Your agency of choice for all types of insurance is McDermott Insurance in Alva. For home, auto, farm, or business insurance, the McDermott Agency will protect what you value most by providing the best coverage and client service possible. To get your custom professional insurance review, call McDermott Insurance at 580-327-3500 or visit them at 526 Flynn Street in Alva. McDermott Insurance. They can't predict the future, but they can insure it.
Alva Health and Wellness is Alva's newest healthcare option, offering a broad array of services geared to address today's most common illnesses and injuries. Alva Health and Wellness offers services for you and your child, including sickness, wellness, chronic care management, vaccinations, weight loss, and so much more. Find more information online by visiting alvahealthandwellness.com or come by and make an appointment with Jeremy Logsdon in person at 515 College Avenue right here in Alva.
Third baseman number 28, Colby Grace, will lead it off. As we move to the bottom of the 8th inning, again, it's 15-8, Arkansas Monticello. Grace 1-for-2 today with 2 RBIs. 1-1 pitch. Swung on a miss for strike 2. Well, at this point, Mike, you just want to get somebody on, get base runners.
Yeah, just swing at good pitches. Don't chase right now, but stay disciplined.
Here's the 1-2. And it's called strike 3, and there's 1 down.
And then with 2 strikes, expand your zone and get after it.
Now Rangers down to their final 5 outs. So again, Trevor Stiles will hit. He's 0-for-3 today. Struck out twice and also flew out to left in the 6th. As Vail misses low and outside for ball 1. Here's the 1-0. That's right down the middle for a called strike. Count evens up 1-1. One-one pitch. Popped up. Let's see if this gets out of play.
It'll be tough.
Catcher Poppy will make the grab in foul territory. And
made a good play.
Well, he did. And Poppy again, a second team All Great American Conference performer a year ago. Well, on his way to that, or maybe first team this year. As Jacob Wiltshire will hit here with 2 down in the bottom of the 8th inning. And now the home plate umpire has called time. He's having a word with the coach at Arkansas Monticello, and he'll go back behind home plate. Not sure what that was about. That pitch swung out and missed. Count is 0-1 to Wiltshire. And the delivery. Fouled back to the net. Count is 0-2. It's always funny to me how people move, when even though that net's there.
I'm an old catcher. I move to it.
Yeah.
Just natural.
Yeah. Count is 0-2 to Wiltshire. And the delivery. That's a line shot to third. That's fielded by Romero. The long throw across, and that'll do it as the Rangers go in order here in the 8th. No runs, no hits, no errors. With nobody left on, we head to the top of the 9th. Rangers trailing at 15-8. This is Northwestern Baseball brought to you by Holder Drug on the Rangers Sports Network.
Don't miss the Monster Truck Spring Nationals. One giant show this Saturday, 8 p.m. Crystal Beach Stadium, Woodward, Oklahoma. See the baddest trucks on the planet in ground-pounding, car-crushing action, including Animal House, driven by the world's youngest female driver. She's only 15 years old. She'll take on Dysfunctional, Kicking and Screaming, Redneck Rampage, and Sergeant Smash. Don't miss the Oklahoma Tough Truck Contest, where locals run for cash. Special VIP box seats and pit passes included. Attendance to the pre-show pit party. Mixed with trucks, autographs, and kids meet Batman. Plus a superhero souvenir. You can even take a ride in a real monster truck. Tickets available at United Grocery, Napa, Cowboy Tech Shop, Woodward Steel, at the gate, or online at showclix.com. Sponsored by Advanced Real Estate Advisors, Ken Cool, Brothers Collision, Northwestern Electric Co-op, K&S Tire, Red Prairie, SPC, Red Dirt Gun and Pawn, and Great Plains Bank. Monster Truck Spring National this Saturday. Woodward. Be there.
Alva State Bank and Trust Company, older than Oklahoma, big enough to serve you and small enough to know you.
We love to give back to our customers. Did you know Alva State Bank offers a great rewards checking account program? That's right. You can earn cash back or high interest with our Kasasa accounts. We will even refund you up to $25 in ATM fees.
How do I qualify?
It's simple. Just swipe your debit card 12 times, sign up for online statements, and have one ACH credit or debit post to your account.
Can I do it online?
Yes. Just visit our website at www.alvastatebank.com to see if our Kasasa Rewards program is right for you.
We make banking easy. Whether you're at home, the office, or in your car, our online or mobile banking options help you juggle busy schedules and financial needs.
We plant roots where others have branches.
Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
Kirk Wolf to lead things off as there's a fly ball into deep right center. Going back, that'll go off the wall and get away from Sayre. Wolf's going to round second. He's headed for third. Here's the throw back in from Barcelo and Sayre. And sliding in safely for the leadoff triple is Wolf. Boy, these guys are seeing the baseball well the last two innings.
They are not missing anything. That was a line drive to center off the wall.
So Wolf now on the game with two doubles. Scored three runs and has a triple. Garrett, who's 2-for-4 today with four RBIs. He's hit two-run home runs, and he's also struck out looking twice. As Phelps delivers outside for ball one, count is 1-0. We're starting to see a few more people out here.
Yeah.
1-0 is inside. Count moves to 2-0. Of course, game two scheduled to start at 6. That'll probably be closer to, I would say, 6:15, maybe 6:20. And the 2-0. Make it 3-0 to Aiden Garrett. Rio pitch. Phelps delivers a called strike. Yeah, goes to 3-1 now to Garrett. And Rangers don't have anybody up. This is pretty much Phelps' one to finish.
Yep.
Try and get out of this here and get the bats back in the ninth as he delivers low for ball four.
Strike.
Oh, it was. Okay, yep. Yeah.
Bring him back.
So I was with Garrett. I thought he was headed down to first. I think he was. And coach at third going to go have a word with Garrett before this 3-2 count. So three balls, two strikes to Aiden Garrett. Just had food arrive, too.
Smells pretty good.
It does. 3-2 pitch. That's a fly ball crushed into right center. Going back. And that one is over the fence for a home run. A two-run shot again by Aiden Garrett, his third of the day. And it's now 17-8.
He hasn't missed a pitch that he's hit. Right on the screws.
Now batting third baseman, Brody Romero.
So now to the plate, third baseman number 23, Brody Romero. As that one cleared the bases again, nobody out. That's in there for a strike to Romero, who's 0-3 today. He was hit by a pitch and scored a run last time up in the eighth. Here's the 0-1. That's up and away for ball one. Counting it's up one ball, one strike. Here's the 1-1. Line drive to left is down for a base hit. Boy, these guys just continue to hit the ball hard.
Yes. Yes, they can use it all up right now.
And it looks like we're going to see Gunnar Haskins come in to pinch hit for Logan Jones. So pinch hitter for the Weevils.
Now batting number 27, Gunnar Haskins.
A 176 hitter, his eighth appearance, three hits and 17 at-bats, four runs. He does have two doubles and two RBIs this season. Phelps checks the runner. That pitch swung on and missed. And Haskins is up there swinging. Count is 0-1. And the 0-1. Going inside for ball one. Count evens up one ball, one strike. After Haskins back to the top of the order with Rock Hawthorne. We see action in the bullpen for the Weevils. They do have a right-handed pitcher up. 1-1. Just missed there. Count goes to 2-1. Phelps with a 2-1. Ground ball hit foul down the third baseline. Count evens up 2-2.
And we just need something good to happen right now. Yeah, you know, good ground ball, do something. Pick us up a little bit. We're getting a little flat out there in the field.
One thing you don't want to happen is just carry over to game two.
Right.
Two pitch. Swung on and missed for strike three. And there's one down. Nice job by Cade Phelps to get the strikeout. That is his 19th of the year. First, it's coming in relief as Rock Hawthorne. It'll be a lefty versus lefty matchup here. As that one misses low into the turf, nice stop from Stiles, but it'll be a 1-0 count to Hawthorne. Weevils got 3 in the 6th, 1 in the 7th. Took that 8-7 lead, and then 7 in the 8th, and so far 2 here in the top of the 9th. They've hit 5 home runs today.
They've got good speed on the bases and at the plate right now, so we're going to have to be really good defensively.
That's a shot into right at Sachin. He'll make the grab. Didn't have to move much for out number 2. So Camden Tanner will now hit. He's 1-for-4 today. Walked and scored a run in the first, flew out to center in the third, grounded out to second in the fifth, doubled and scored a run in the seventh, and flew out to center again in the eighth. That's a line drive right into left.
Nice play. Needed that.
Carson Wright makes the grab, and that'll do it. Here in the top of the ninth, as the Weevils do pick up 2 more runs on 2 hits, no errors, with nobody left on. Bottom of the ninth we go. Last chance for the Rangers when we come back. as they trail it 17-8 on the Community Bank scoreboard. This is Northwestern Baseball brought to you by Holder Drug on the Ranger Sports Network.
Holder Drug has been serving the community of Alva since 1952. When you are in need of medication, healthcare items, and more, look to none other than Holder Drug, Alva's local pharmacy. Holder Drug is locally and family-owned and is always ready to serve you. They offer convenient drive-through pickup as well as free delivery with your medication. They also offer a number of gift ideas for those special holidays. For more information, visit their website, www.holderdrug.com, or stop by 513 Barnes Avenue in downtown Alva.
Community Bank has been serving Alva, Oklahoma, and the surrounding area since 1984. Community Bank was founded by local community members who wanted to ensure the banking needs of the community were being met. It has been our goal since inception to provide customer-focused services and community development. Our customers are friends, neighbors, and never just a number. We believe in investing in our community, and we pride ourselves in being your hometown bank. Community Bank, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
Do you need assistance taking care of yourself or a loved one? Beatles Nursing Home in Alva is here for you. We offer safe, high-quality, affordable nursing care while meeting all care guidelines for living. Call us at 580-327-1274 to learn more about our admissions process to place your loved one in our care. When it's time to choose a nursing home facility, we'll hope you'll consider Beatles Nursing Home, located at 916 Noble Street in Alva.
Welcome back here to Meyer Stadium as Weevils will go to the bullpen here in the ninth. And it's brought to you by Ignite Physical Therapy. This change, the 6'3" junior right-handed pitcher out of Bryan, Arkansas, number 15, Trey Miller. Miller has 5.79 earned run average, 0-1, 11th appearance, 9 1/3, 10 hits, 6 runs, all those earned, 15 walks to 8 strikeouts. Teams are hitting .286 against him this year. As Rangers will have the top of the order due up here in the bottom of the ninth as the first pitch to Bradford is inside for ball one. Here's the 1-0. Upstairs, count moves to 2-0 now.
Back to rejoining you. And great having Mike in town. And God, he used to kill the ball here when he was a player.
Probably still could, couldn't you?
You know, I was looking at it down there.
Fly ball lifted into left. This will be Wolf who's got the track on it. He'll make the grab, and there's one down.
I think after a few practice pitches, I could probably maybe get up to speed and get that bat through the zone, but I may tear something doing it.
Now batting for the Rangers, Carson Wright.
Now to the plate, left fielder number 31, Carson Wright. Fly ball hit into center, and this will be Hawthorne who makes the grab, and there's two down. Actually, I think we had a little bit of a switch. I think Hawthorne is now in right. Now nonetheless, there's two down as the Rangers are down to their final out. As Paul Sachin to the plate, he swings and misses there. Count is 0-1.
I'm kind of cheating, Dustin. I'm eating this. Potato salad, mac and cheese with some jalapeno and this brat, and oh my goodness.
Count is 0-2 to Sachin. Man, that one misses upstairs. Count moves to 1-2. Sachin 1-for-3 today, walked once, struck out once.
Yep, folks, grow up to be a color guy instead of a play-by-play guy. You get a lot more freedom and you don't have to know much.
1-2 pitches. Foul back as it gets over the press box.
And the bump doesn't even put me into a higher tax bracket. It's perfect.
1-2 pitch upcoming from Miller. That's way outside. Count evens up 2-2. Yeah, Rangers down to their final out. They trail it 17-8 here in the ninth. 2-2 pitch. Ball three, count goes full now, 3-2. Again, Rangers have given up 10 runs over the last three innings. 3-2 pitch, swung on a miss for strike three, and that will do it here in game one of our doubleheader as Arkansas Monticello takes game one by a final score of 17-8 with the win. The Weebles now 21-17, 17-8 in conference play. Rangers dropped two in a row now after losing on Tuesday as well to 26-14, 16-9 in Great American Conference play, and now 19-5 here at Meyer Stadium. 17-8 is your final score. We will take a timeout and wrap it up with our McDermott Insurance postgame show next. This is Northwestern Baseball brought to you by Holder Drug on the Ranger Sports Network 105.7.
Here at Bank Central, we like to shoot for three, and that includes our services to you. From fee-free checking accounts to competitive CD rates and all the way to consumer lending, stop by any of our locations in Alva, Enid, Woodward, and Cherokee, or call 580-327-1122 to talk with one of our qualified professionals. Bank Central, where we're centered on you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Certain fees and restrictions may apply.
You put in the work, and every day you go out and prove it again. You're an expert in your field. That's what farmers do every day. They go out and get the job done. If that's you, then Farm Credit of Western Oklahoma wants to thank you. For a livestock or crop loan, equipment loan, ag real estate, or operating loan, we will tailor a loan to your needs. Talk to one of our ag specialists by phone or stop by a branch today. Farm Credit of Western Oklahoma, an equal housing opportunity lender, online at farmcreditloans.com.
Get no better deal in the country than at Croft Country, located in Alva, Oklahoma. Croft Country is the dealer for vehicles in Northwest Oklahoma. Croft Country is locally owned and operated since 1985, offering a full line of award-winning brands including Chevy and GMC. From the time you enter our showroom for sales or service, you can expect to be treated like family. So the next time you're in the market for a new or used vehicle, come see us right here in Alva, located at 401 East Oklahoma Boulevard.
Anger, anxiety, worry, and disbelief, these are normal emotions to feel with an unplanned pregnancy. You have options, and you are not alone. Hope Pregnancy Center in Alva is a safe, confidential, and compassionate place to land. Hope offers free pregnancy testing and ultrasound, and you will be provided education for all your options. Remember, you aren't alone. We can help with Hope. Visit thinkimpregnant.org. That's thinkimpregnant.org.
To prevent medication from getting into the wrong hands, it is crucial to store it out of sight and out of the reach of children and visitors. In addition, it is important to dispose of unwanted, expired, and unused medications in a safe manner. For more information, visit okimready.org. That's okimready.org, or call 988 Oklahoma's Mental Health Lifeline. This program is funded by Northwestern Oklahoma State University, Oklahoma Department of Mental Health and Substance Abuse Prevention Services, and Substance Abuse Mental Health Services Administration.
Welcome back to Meyer Stadium as we open up the McDermott Insurance postgame show. Arkansas Monticello winner here in game one by a final score of 17-8. And let's run through the final numbers real quick. The Weevils sent 41 to the plate, 17 runs on 16 hits, 16 RBIs, 4 walks. They struck out 8 times, left 3 runners on. Rangers sent 36 to the plate, 8 runs, 9 hits, 8 RBIs, 3 walks, 9 strikeouts, and left 4 runners on here this afternoon, as the Weevils got 2 in the first, 2 in the fourth, 3 in the sixth, 1 in the seventh, and 7 in the eighth, and 2 more in the ninth. Rangers with 7 in the third and 1 more in the seventh to end this one. Irvin again goes, got the start, does not get a decision today, as McDaniel will pick up the win. He goes to 3-1, 2 innings, 1 run, 1 earned, 1 walk, 1 strikeout. Starter Irvin goes 4 innings, 8 hits, 7 runs, all those earned, 2 walks, and 5 strikeouts. Bale, 2 innings and a hit, 2 strikeouts. Miller, 1 inning and 1 strikeout. Haas got the start, 5 innings, 5 runs, all those 4 of those earned. 3 walks, 5 strikeouts. Toborgs takes the loss as he moves to 2 and 3. 2 and a third, 5 hits, 7 runs, all those earned. 1 walk, 2 strikeouts. Gescheidel, 3rd of an inning, 1 hit, 1 run, 1 earned. Shaw gives up 2 hits, 2 runs, 2 earned. And Phelps, an inning and a third, 3 hits, 2 runs, both of those earned, and 1 strikeout, as it adds up to a 17-8 victory for the Weevils. And coach, a tough one in game one, as Rangers got off to a tremendous start, had that big lead at 7-2, and boy, give credit to the Weevils, they just absolutely kept hitting, you know, probably a word I can't say, yeah. Out of the ball the rest of the day.
Knocking and, I mean, the stitching out of it.
Yeah, that's the best way to describe it. I mean, everything just was hit so hard by the Weevils here in game one.
It's a strange game, and it's a cruel game sometimes, and kind of on the receiving end of cruel here in this game one. Wasn't a lot of difference. It's just we couldn't get them out after, you know, after a point, and it's not because we were doing anything wrong necessarily. They just had a really good run of fortune and pretty much put it away. And as I don't know if you'd heard in the background, but earlier, you know, in the old Army, we used to say, expend all ammo, which we were leaving a range. And I'm kind of hoping that's what they did. They, you know, expended all their ammo for, and we're going to be, you know, locked and loaded for game two here and then tomorrow's game. So
no doubt. And that's one thing I talked about with Coach Bowen is how important it was to get game one. I know it's always tough, and especially, you know, when you have the doubleheader on Friday, you never want to get down 2-0, you know, having to survive and win that third final game. So the Rangers are going to have to bounce back here in game two, and hopefully this doesn't carry over what I talked about earlier into game two.
No, I don't think it'll carry over. I mean, guys know each game's important, and I'm sure they'll be ready.
So again,
I just hope we have a little bit more fortune this game than we did last game. Just got away there late.
It did. Again, the Weevils scored 10 runs the last three innings to win it by a final score of 17-8. As that wraps it up for our McDermott Insurance post-game show, we're going to take a break for about 30 minutes. We believe it'll be about 6:15, something like that, when game two of our doubleheader will start. We're going to go back to the studio. We'll be back here with you for game two shortly. So, again, keep it locked right here on Classic Hits 105.7.